Isaiah Thomas and the Detroit Pistons are relishing their role as the upstart challengers in the Eastern Conference Finals. They have confronted the world champion Celtics with pride and resolve. And while they trail the series 3-2, the brash Pistons return home tonight where they've been virtually unbeatable. Defending an NBA title is no easy task. Just ask the Boston Celtics. The grueling playoff grind has transformed Celtic green into battered shades of black and blue. But true character often triumphs over adversity, and such is the case with Boston. They lead this series because when a hero was needed, the Celtics looked around and up stepped Larry Bird. His last second steal in Game 5 will forever be etched in history, as Boston is now one victory away from the NBA Finals. This has been a series of contrasts, from textbook basketball to unmitigated violence. And tonight, the Pistons need to survive one more battle. And CBS Sports welcomes you to its coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs. This is the cavernous Pontiac Silverdome in Pontiac, Michigan, and tonight they are expecting 30,000 fans for game number 6 of the Eastern Conference Final between the defending world champions, the Boston Celtics, and their challengers, the Detroit Pistons. Waiting in the wings are the Los Angeles Lakers, who swept Seattle on Monday. Meanwhile, Boston will try to wrap it up and go to L.A., and Detroit will try to survive and force the 7th game. And good evening, everyone. I'm Dick Stockton. There are two major principals in this playoff who are not here tonight in the Silverdome. One is the Boston Celtics head coach, Casey Jones. He's in San Francisco for the funeral of his mother, Eula Jones, who passed away on Monday. And in his place, Jimmy Rogers, the Celtic assistant, will handle the reins along with Chris Ford. The other man who's not here tonight for the Boston Celtics is their very fine center, Robert Parish. As a result of a punching foul, he was fined $7,500 and, more important, was suspended by one game by the NBA. And he will not be playing today. And the Celtics claim he would have played if there had not been a suspension. Let me bring in my partner, Tommy Heinsohn. Naturally, Tommy, the effects of not having Robert Parish here on the Boston Celtics tonight.
Well, psychologically, the Pistons would suspect that they might have an easy one. They better not be thinking that way, because historically, NBA teams play better when they dig down deep and recoup for the loss of a key player. They're going to miss Parish, his rebounding, his shot blocking, but it's going to be a tough game for Boston, but they'll dig down deep.
Speaking of digging down deep, did they ever do it better than in game number 5 when Larry Bird made that miraculous play along with Dennis Johnson to win a game that the Pistons had in their back pocket? And the question would have to be, how do the Pistons respond to that shocking loss?
I'll tell you, I was very impressed with the way the Pistons handled that. Normally, under those circumstances, you might see some finger pointing. Not one thing did I see in the press by any player saying Isaiah shouldn't have done this or done that. They played it perfectly. I think they're ready to win this ballgame.
Crowd's ready, I know that. The home court has held form throughout this series. We'll see what happens tonight. Game 6, Celtics and Pistons. It's the NBA on CBS.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Miller Lite. For great taste, there's only one light beer. The Hartford, the insurance people of ITT. And by Fram, Bendix, and Autolite, which are all quality products of Allied Automotive.
When I played hoops, I could beat anybody. Still can. Yo, Chief, little one-on-one or what?
Get out of town, man.
Chicken! At least I can enjoy a Miller Lite while I'm looking for a game, right? How about you, Peanut? Wimp. Light tastes great, but these bean poles probably drink it because it's less filling. Hey, yo, bean pole, you want to show me what you got? Tricks are easy. I'd like to get this turkey on the court.
It's no contest. There's only one light beer, Miller Lite.
Today, you need an insurance company that looks out for you, with experience you can count on, and a firm financial footing. You need the Hartford. When you need us most, we're at our best. That's the Hartford difference.
In a class by itself, the Road Attract from Norelco.
Inside three floating heads, 45 lifters and cutters grip and raise for an incredibly close, incredibly comfortable shave with the blade never touching the skin. The close, comfortable Rotatrak shave from Norelco.
Maybe you'll be lucky. Maybe you'll just have to replace your connecting rods. But maybe you'll need new valves. Then your bearings and crankshaft could go. Maybe even your rings and pistons. But you can help prevent all this for just a few dollars with a Fram Wear Guard oil filter. A leading consumer magazine rated Fram Best. So you can pay a few dollars now or a lot later.
Hey, dude. What you driving?
Dodge. Dakota S. Toyota?
Yeah. Who could ask for anything more?
Well, how about halogen headlamps, rack and pinion steering, 15-gallon fuel tank, cigar lighter, wheel covers, P195 tires, a new 770 protection plan, and a price that's hundreds less. See you later, dude.
Oh, what a feeling.
Set you up with the starting lineups for tonight's game. And Darren Day, who's seen plenty of action off the bench, will start it forward. Kevin McHale moves to center. Danley, Mahorn, Laimbeer, Thomas, and Dumars. That's been the starting five throughout for Detroit. Ed Rush and Joe Crawford are the working officials. Bill Saar is the alternate. There's Isaiah Thomas, who's determined to make amends for that pass that resulted in a Piston victory turning into defeat. Detroit in white, Celtics in green, and Pistons are undefeated in the playoffs at home. Thomas misses the first shot of the game, and McHale gets the rebound. Tommy, Boston can't get into a running game with Detroit.
Well, they've got the speed out there. Might not be too bad for them to get some easy baskets, but Bird has got to have a monster offensive night tonight, and particularly shoot well.
Danny Ainge, who returned to action in the fourth game with a sprained knee, gives the Celtics the lead. Joe Dumars and Thomas in the backcourt. Danley in the low post, where he's effective, ties the score.
That is the half-court matchup that has been so successful for the Pistons. Nobody has been able to stop Adrian Danley with a green uniform.
He has led the Pistons in scoring the last three games. Ainge, who hit outside, comes back inside, and it's 4-2. So the matchups, Dennis Johnson is on Dumars, Ainge will be on Isaiah Thomas, and the big matchup, Day on Danley. And we'll have a foul call, loose ball foul, against the Celtics. Here's the way the series has gone so far. The Pistons have won the games by the big margins, and the Celtics, in their last two victories, have won the close ones, and nothing could have been closer than Game 5 on Tuesday night. The foul was on Larry Bird. And Antley misses a layup. Celtics with the lead.
The Pistons have been very content to stay with their half-court offense, allowing Adrian Danley to really control the offense.
Chuck Daly, the second oldest coach in the NBA, after Jack Ramsey. And the most successful coach the Pistons have ever had. McHale posting up against Laimbeer and is pushed by Laimbeer. Tommy, Laimbeer has been unfazed despite the fact that he's been the center of the storm in this series. The first, the takedown of Larry Bird, in which he was fined $5,000. And then, of course, the victim of Robert Parrish's punches the other night.
He sure came back and shot well in Boston.
And there's Bird, who you feel has to come out shooting strong. Bad pass by Laimbeer trying to get the outlet. Foul, and Larry Bird will go to the line. And Isaiah Thomas commits his first personal foul.
Larry Bird with the line for Boston.
Dick Bird has got to have such a good shooting night. I think he needs to be up somewhere near the 40-point mark and shoot very well so that there are no rebounds, so that the Pistons can convert into fast break opportunities.
Larry Bird is shooting only 43% in the series, although he is the leading scorer for Boston. He has helped the team with his assists and his rebounds. But tonight he's got to be on the mark, and he's really struggled from the field thus far.
Isaiah has not handled the ball an awful lot here in this first quarter. They are relying on other people to create pace, not Isaiah.
Bill Laimbeer. That's that's his specialty, the outside shot. And when he's hot, he can hit us up to 60% from the field. Darren Day, McHale, who is the leading offensive rebounder in the series, and it's an 8-4 in favor of Boston.
A pace very much the way the Celtics would like it.
Half-court game. Thomas is open. And an air ball thrown up by Isaiah Thomas. He's looking for an opportunity. Pistons get back defensively. And Ainge buries one, and Danny Ainge has 6 points now.
That was one of those, no. Great shot, Danny.
Day is now on Dumars, and now they switch back to Dennis Johnson. Dumars gets it. Laimbeer saves it. The Pistons have been red hot shooting, but they're ice cold starting this game. And the basket counts by Darren Day on a drive.
The Celtics are ever so ready to fast break when they have an opportunity. The Pistons are trying to slow it down.
And a 20-second timeout called by Pistons coach Chuck Daly as the Celtics get off strong to a 12-4 lead. Whichever team has had the scoring edge in starting front court has won each game. That has been the history of the series, and so that's the gauge we will watch tonight. And keep in mind that the Celtics enter the game without Robert Parish, who, by the way, is at home watching this game. He did make the trip, and the Celtics said he was going to play, but the suspension for the game eliminated that. The Pistons feel, however, that he wasn't going to play and that the suspension is really a papier-mâché situation.
It was done regardless, and it certainly will have an effect on this game. They had listed Robert Parish as probable in all the other games that he played, so I would assume that he would have played in this one if he was able without the suspension.
The horn is fouled inside. And there's an example of Isaiah Thomas penetrating, which...
Here's Isaiah being a playmaker. Bird has to go out and make the adjustment. He slides through the defense and really had the shot. And I think trying to be a teammate, try to create an opportunity for Mahorn when he really had the shot himself.
Foul is on Darren Day, each team with two personal fouls. And here's Rick Mahorn, who's taken on the role of an enforcer over this club. He was a big factor in games 1, 3, and 4 as a rebounder, scorer, or both. And in games 2 and 5, he was basically silent, and he misses both of his free throw attempts.
He made he did a great job on Parish, blocking him off the offensive glass.
Celtics lead still 12-4. 8.5 to play in the first period. McHale close range. And the Celtics lead by 10. And in the Silverdome, the Pistons have blown out the Celtics in the two previous games. There's Adrian Dantley doing what he does best.
No fast break opportunities yet or hard pushes by the Pistons.
Ainge misses, and there's Laimbeer getting it out to Dumars. Dantley doesn't get the spin, and now the Celtics. Bird. And Bird starts off the game cold, and Detroit 2-on-2. Trailer Thomas. Bird defending against Adrian Dantley. And will pick up his second personal foul.
Celtics getting back very nicely on this fast break. Laimbeer picks out the man right away. And off they come. But there's four green jerseys going to get into this defense. And look, they cut off the penetration of Dantley. And a nice tip pass to start the break for the Celtics by Darren Day.
They call the foul on McHale from behind, and that is McHale's first personal foul.
Dantley is so much more effective if he can get up on the front end of the break before the Celtics defense gets set, because he can use that very effective spin move a lot better.
Acquired from the Utah Jazz for Kelly Trepuka and Kent Benson to give the Pistons some inside offense, and he is delivered in that form. So Detroit has scored 4 in a row after trailing by 10. But still cold from the field. McHale over Laimbeer. Into the hands of Thomas. Celtics back defensively. High off the glass, and Isaiah Thomas scores his first point.
And under control that time.
Darren Day sneaks in between Laimbeer and Thomas to break a six-point run by the Pistons.
I think that the Pistons not prepared to see the Celtics break quite as much as they have been doing.
Danley gets the bucket, and Adrian Danley, doing it all from inside, has 8 points, and he's the game's high scorer.
He may wear out before the end of the first half, however. He's handled almost every possession.
6:45 remaining in the first period. Day goes right around the Pistons, and Mahorn was anchored to the floor.
Mahorn doesn't have the agility to really stay with Darren Day in the open court.
Day has 6 points. He and Ainge lead the Celtics. Laimbeer under the backboard after a good pass turns it over to the Celtics, who have led all the way in this first period, nearly halfway through the opening stanza.
Ooh, I like that. Want that. And you can get it at Color Tile. We're the tile experts.
Even for this problem?
We've got an answer for every problem. Our range of quality tiles in great colors and patterns make rooms beautiful. Plus now, save 50% and more on a huge selection during our hottest summer sale.
50% and more?
On ceramic tile, fine vinyl tile, mosaic tiles, and more. And we'll show you how to install it.
You do have all the answers.
That's us, Color Tile, the tile experts.
They're here. They're scary. Strange, alien creatures. Run for cover. Run for safety. Run for your light. Run to wherever Miller Lite is sold and look for this special display. Because in specially marked cases of Miller Lite, there's a chance to be an instant winner of up to $100,000. But hurry, because they drink Miller Lite too, and the end is near.
We're doomed.
Sweepstakes ends June 30th, 1987.
We got fans. We give 110%. Give 110% and expect it. From everyone, everything.
Speedstick antiperspirant gives 110%. Why? It's the most powerful protection you can get. Nothing fights wetness and odor better. Glides on dry, lasts all day. That's 110% protection.
Speedstick antiperspirant, the wide stick.
That's your edge.
I'm Menon.
The suspension of Robert Parish creates several problems for the Boston Celtics. First, it takes a seven-footer off the offensive glass, where he's been Boston's best in the playoffs. It removes him from a very successful pick-and-roll play. The Pistons have had problems defending early in the series. And it hurts Boston's team defense, where Parish stands at the last line of defense. Detroit can take advantage of all this by continuing to up-tempo the game with Isaiah as a scorer, as well as a playmaker. And by hitting the offensive glass, particularly off the bench, with Dennis Rodman and John Sally.
And John Sally, who leads the Pistons in offensive rebounding, and a quick, active rookie from Georgia Tech, has come in the game replacing Rick Mahorn. And the other good-looking rookie is Dennis Rodman, who will see a lot of action.
I don't think the Pistons have truly utilized the speed of either one of those two players as effectively as it could have been done.
Alley-oop to Dennis Johnson. With Sally on him, Johnson turns around and throws up an air ball. Pistons can cut it to four. Laimbeer. And Bird the rebound. Outlets to Day. They can run, unusual for the Celtic team that doesn't like to do it that much. Danny Ainge over the top, and it'll be piston ball. And Tommy, you talked about Adrian Danley and how hard he's been working with 8 points. He has taken six of the Pistons' 13 shots in this game.
Now here's the man that really I think should be turned loose, Isaiah Thomas. Without the shot blocker in there, he's going to be able to penetrate at will.
10 on the shot clock. They go to Danley again, double, leaving Dumars open for the easy hoop.
And there is a perfect example of where Robert Parish has missed. Nobody got down there for the shot clock.
18 to 14, the Celtics had a 10-point lead. Thomas on top of Ainge. Danley on Bird, and foul against Adrian Danley will be his first personal foul.
You watch now on the weak side of the court, the side of the court away from the ball. Nobody makes an adjustment. Danny Ainge the only man there, and he certainly is not a shot blocker. Parish is usually the guy that hangs around in there to make those kind of blocks on penetration.
Each team with three team fouls in this opening period, and Day held back Adrian Dantley. And Darren Day has picked up two fouls here in the first period. Jimmy Rogers had a lot of way to go here. Different alternatives. He could have started Greg Kite with the same forward lineup of Bird and McHale, and he could have started Fred Roberts. Instead, he went with the quicker lineup, using McHale at center and Day at forward.
I think Jimmy Rogers is under the gun. He's like the general got shot, and they're asking a lieutenant to run things on the D-Day invasion.
Dantley gets the roll and 10 points. Well, Tommy, a lot of people are looking at Jimmy Rogers as a prospective head coaching talent of his own right, so there may be a lot of clubs watching to see what he does in this game, too. McHale double team. The Pistons are rotating very well, not giving the easy shot to the Celtics, and McHale manages to draw the foul on an off-balance attempt.
One of the best ways to stop a team from running is to go and move the ball around four or five passes. Now, here's Dantley. They have not solved him at all. He is able with that wide body and that dribbling ability to defeat any of the defenders Boston has put on him in this entire series.
A technical foul has been called against Darren Day. And Adrian Dantley will shoot the technical. So rambunctious Darren Day, who is a new face on the Celtics this year after playing with the Bullets and the Chicago Bulls for one day, actually called for the technical. Not appreciating the last foul called on him, and Adrian Dantley doesn't take advantage of it.
He certainly cannot blow his cool with the Celtics as undermanned as they are.
Vinny Johnson, whose nickname is the Microwave, and he's truly lived up to that nickname, has come into the ball game, replacing Isaiah Thomas, and Vinny Johnson can heat up in a hurry, and quite a shooter, and get on one of those streaks of his.
Vinny Johnson, I think, is part of the strategy of Chuck Daly to keep Isaiah emotionally under control in these games. They have let him handle the ball club like the team leader while Isaiah has even been on the floor. He's done a pretty good job of it, too.
One out of two for McHale. In the third game, Thomas was on the bench for 9 minutes, and Vinny Johnson ran the club, and the Pistons ran up a good lead.
But he is not a pace man.
Dantley against Day, and Darren Day has picked up his third personal foul. And that'll send Jimmy Rogers to the bench and bring in Fred Roberts. You know what they call him? Norm. They call Fred Roberts Norm because he reminds the Celtics of Norman Bates, the character in Psycho.
He needs a haircut. Put down the knife, Norm.
He's started a lot of games. He's been an active guy off the bench this season for the Celtics early.
But he has not been able to do damage against Dantley either. And they were teammates. And I think Dantley does not have any respect for Roberts because he must have been able to handle him so easily in a practice session.
Dantley has missed two free throws. And the Pistons are only 2 of 6 from the line. And they're not shooting well from the line. Under 70%. That's not a good percentage so far in the series. The Celtics lead is cut to 2, 19-17. They are already in the penalty in personal fouls. The Pistons have committed 4. One more and they're in the penalty. Bird has a screen from McHale. Sally, the 7-footer, is on Bird here. And spins around with a left-handed shot and the first field goal for Larry Bird, and the Celtics are up by 4.
When there's a big man on him, he goes outside. When there's a small man on him, he's going inside, Larry Bird, playing with his head.
And the Celtics, who are in the penalty, the foul is on Fred Roberts, his first, and so Detroit will shoot 2. And now Jimmy Rogers goes to his bench for Greg Kite, the big center.
Here's Fred Roberts just trying to deny Dantley that low post position. He almost shoved him up into the balcony. It looked like a field goal attempt.
Started one game in the playoffs and is a banger off the boards, but foul prone in his own right. And Kevin McHale leaving the game. McHale who had the flu this afternoon and a bad stomach, is all right coming into the game, but a little weakened, according to the team doctor, has 5 points.
Yeah, he looks so bad. He looks like he never finished the march at Bataan. That's how bad he's been looking.
You are so well schooled in military history, Tommy, that I think that's where you got your degree at Holy Cross. 21-15. The Celtics have led all the way. 21-19 make it with 3:44 remaining. And Larry Bird with his second straight basket.
And he's doing a tune on Sally's head. Sally's trying to deny him the outside shot, and Bird is just up faking and going right by him.
Out!
Vinnie Johnson passes it off to Lane Beer. Again, a two-point game.
They worked that pick and roll, their version of the pick and roll, so well with Lambeer popping to the corner.
3 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the first period. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn here at the Silver Dome. Celtics at one time had a 10-point lead. Danny Ainge gives them the 4-point margin again.
That is a must man tonight. Danny Ainge has got to hit about 20 points and shoot well from the outside.
And another foul on Roberts. Fred Roberts with his second foul, both teams in the penalty, and a timeout. With just under 3 minutes to go, first period.
In the truck warranty game, the winning hand still belongs to Dodge. 7 years or 70,000 miles. So for anybody out there who wants to call our guarantee, read them and weep.
Now from Dodge, get your choice of 3-7 financing or $1,000 cash back on new Dodge Ram Chargers in stock, or $500 cash back on new Dakotas and full-size pickups and wagons.
The Great American Face. Strong. Sensitive. The Great American Razor. Actra Plus. Solid. With the Lubra Smooth Strip for extra protection. The Great American Face deserves the Great American Shave. Actra Plus. Only from Gillette.
All I had to do was open my eyes and see that Alpo costs the same as other dries. Well, I did.
Alpo Beef Flavored Dinner. More meat protein than 10 pounds of steak at a really good price.
I got you the Alpo. Now you got to clean the fish.
I spend 3 to 5 hours a day talking to my clients on the phone, buying and selling for them. So when our phone system packed up the other day, it was impossible. It was a mess. I make my livelihood on the phone, my commissions. Without a telephone, I'm broke.
The finals on CBS Sports. We will rock you.
We will rock you.
Tommy, there have been over $30,000 in fines handed out by the NBA because of the violence, skirmish, fight, whatever you want to call it. Your thoughts on the latest? Robert Parish fined $7,500, but suspended for a game.
I think suspension during the playoffs really is penalizing the team. They should have fined him a significant amount of money if they thought that was that severe an incident. But it really hurts the team. Maybe during the regular season, but not in the playoffs to suspend him for a game.
Yeah, I think over the big picture, forgetting about Lambeer against Parish, and the fact is I think the NBA is intent on ending what has gone on. They don't want to get a hockey syndrome where they have fights all the time. And I think the idea of the suspension is to really come down hard. And it just seems that Robert Parish is the example being made of, where they're saying, look, we're going to put an end to fighting, and we're going to go as far as suspending you from a game. And that's how I interpret it. And if it brings an end to the fights, then maybe it's the best thing.
Well, you don't want fights, but they also have to realize that these teams are playing each other potentially 7 times, and that type of thing really creates additional intensity game to game, and they've got to live with that. I think the officials really have to call these games in a different manner. The players know how to police themselves if the officials do the right job.
Isaiah Thomas is back into the ball game for the Detroit Pistons, and his team with Vinnie Johnson in the backcourt, and Adrian Dantley continues to struggle from the free throw line. The score.
They have not really let Dennis Johnson, the Celtics, bring the ball up an awful lot. They're trying to conserve him. Other people have been bringing up the ball, particularly Darren Day when he was in there.
Kite setting a screen for Ainge. Thomas stays with him. And an offensive foul is called against Danny Ainge. And that was a fine play by Isaiah Thomas, staying with Ainge all the way and fighting through the screen.
Well, he got right to him. Danny Ainge can't flow by Isaiah. Isaiah, his foot speed is too fast.
The Celtics have committed five fouls guarding Adrian Dantley. Three by Day and two by Roberts. So they haven't solved that puzzle. Now Dennis Johnson and Bird around. Three on the shot clock. Vinnie Johnson. And Dantley keeps it alive for the Pistons. Chance for Detroit to cut it to one. Vinnie Johnson.
The type of opportunity that Isaiah can create when the ball's in his hands, when he's got his head up and he knows the defense is all sacked in. Vinny and Lambeer are wide open.
Under 2 minutes to go, first period. Celtics have led all the way. And the basket counts and a foul by Thomas. And every time the Pistons close to within a couple, Danny Ainge hits a long-range shot, and Ainge has 10 points. Thomas with his second personal. And Dumars quickly comes back, and Isaiah gets to sit again. A three-point situation for Danny Ainge. Really turned out to be an underrated player and came into his own in a big way this year. Very quick player and defensively made his mark.
Well, he will not be under the gun defensively guarding Dumas as much as he was guarding Isaiah.
Pistons have 13 seconds to try a shot.
Pistons have been really outstanding in this playoff series by penetrating, kicking it out, getting the Celtics defense to sag in, and then hitting that 20-foot shot.
Mahorn gets another chance. 28-26.
Without Parish and McHale in there, the Celtics cannot control a defensive board.
Celtics get the rebound and Dennis Johnson. And a loose ball foul called against the Celtics. And Fred Roberts picks up his third personal foul. So Roberts and Day, each with three fouls in the first period.
You'll have a choice right now, Greg Kite. Go for the rebound or block out Rick Mahorn. He does neither, and Mahorn just steps inside after the shot and comes up and puts it off the glass for an easy, very easy two.
Here's Rick Mahorn, who slimmed down and started the last seven games of the regular season and the playoffs for Detroit at power forward. Danny Ainge gets a well-deserved breather and is replaced by Jerry Seastick. Mahorn makes one of two, and the Celtics still cling to the lead. Crowd booing every time Larry Bird touches the ball. Kite, and Greg Kite is fouled. Dennis Rodman committing his first personal.
With Rodman and Sally in the lineup now, they have a tremendous speed advantage over the Celtics big guys, even though Fred Roberts is in for Boston.
Kevin McHale is back in, and Fred Roberts goes out with three fouls.
They are not playing Adrian Dantley effectively. They're trying to body Adrian Dantley, and that's what he loves the most.
Got it. Kite connects on one out of two, and the Pistons looking to tie the game with under a minute to play in the first period. Vinny Johnson, strong to the hoop, is pushed, and will have a chance to do just that.
A little pick and roll at the head of the key. Somebody's got to step up and deny the penetration. That time, Greg Kite did not even move his feet, and Vinny Johnson with that real spring and good first step just blew right by Greg Kite.
He could tie the game here. Kite with his first foul. The team with the home court edge has won each game. And we have a tie game. That's the first tie since 2-2 to start it all off. Feasting, a good outside shooter who started the first few games of the series. McHale with those long arms converts the offensive rebound.
Like a stalk reaching out and grabbing the ball.
31 seconds to go in the first period. And a difference of 7 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Kenny Johnson ties the score again.
Burning Dennis Johnson with that pick. He can't get his feet moving. He can't stay with Vinny Johnson.
Celtics playing for the last shot of a high scoring first period. And Bird gets the roll with 2 seconds remaining. And Dumars gets it off, but after the sound, and that's the end of the first period. But the score, Celtics 33, the Pistons 31. And we'll return to the Pontiac Silverdome in Michigan after this word from your local station.
The new Mitsubishi Mighty Max, patiently crafted to be serious fun for the money. Only $64.99. Mighty Max gives you more standard features than Toyota, Nissan, or Mazda. And it's still priced lower than all three. And right now, special factory incentives could save you hundreds. The Mitsubishi Mighty Max. When you're ready for some serious fun for the money, it's ready to kick up a little dust. Mitsubishi.
Before you bet your business on an unproven PC, see how AT&T comes through. Right now, every AT&T PC you buy saves you money on your next PC. The more AT&T PCs you add, the less you'll pay for each one. Now more than ever, it pays to put AT&T confidence on everybody's desk. See your participating dealer or call right now.
To be in love, the passion, the hurt, the anger, the happiness. I'm in love with basketball, a passionate and emotional game. But the happiness that I reach through basketball is worth all the pain. America's game, it's fantastic.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Nissan's Pathfinder, named Best 4x4 of the Year by both Four Wheeler and Four Wheel and Off-Road magazines. AT&T, the right choice. And by Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade is thirsty for that deep down body thirst.
Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn here. After one period of play, the Celtics lead the Pistons by two. Adrian Dantley has not been solved by the Celtics. Both teams have shot very well. And we know that in Boston Garden, without air conditioning, it gets awfully hot and humid when we get to May and June. But they have some air here at the Silverdome in Pontiac, Michigan. Yet, it is awfully hot and humid. Before the game, we had temperatures in the 80s and that kind of humidity. And Tom, the Pistons, with a great opportunity without Robert Parish to really set the early pace, have failed to do so.
In the first two wins out here in the Silverdome, they were big leads in the first quarter. They paced the game better in the first quarter than they have tonight.
Next screen.
McHale blocked out of bounds by Rodman. Dantley scored 14 to lead the Pistons in the first period. Ainge led with 11 for Boston.
You look at Rodman come from way up near the foul line to make that block. That's some shot block by a forward.
Dennis Johnson misses a three-point attempt, and here's Vinny Johnson trying to push it up. Feasting is guarding him. And Vinny Johnson left Feasting in the dust. Our fourth tie of this game. The Celtics led by 10 early on.
Celtics trying to slow it down now, not let the Pistons score in clusters.
Rodman is on Bird, and illegal defense is called against the Detroit Pistons. That's a warning. The next time will result in a technical.
Feasting is trying to delay Vinny Johnson from really getting up, and there's a little wet spot on the floor, and Feasting just could not put the traction on with the sneakers, and Vinny will hurt you.
First foul on Rick. And Billy Beer checks back in the game for the Pistons, and Mahorn goes out.
Kevin McDowell with the
The Pistons have, Dick, right now, a speed unit in there with Sally. Well, I guess Sally just went out and Dantley's back in there. But they've got to really go out and run. And Rodman is the guy that really can start to crack the McHales and Parishes, because they get tired around, McHale and Bird. They get tired right around this period of time.
Pistons looking for their first lead of the game. And a foul against Detroit. And it'll be against Dennis Rodman, his second foul.
That little pick at the head of the key is causing so many problems for Dennis Johnson guarding Vinnie Johnson.
Dennis Johnson is a tired veteran guard. Dr. Tom Silver says it's chronic fatigue that's affected number three, Dennis Johnson. He's got the ball now. Bird off the screen, and an offensive foul called against the Celtics. And that'll be Greg Kite's second personal foul. Already the Celtics with Darren Day and Fred Roberts with three personals apiece. Minute and a half gone by, second period. Dantley is double teamed. Tough shot by Dantley, and Bird clears.
Bird played him beautifully that time.
McHale saves it nicely and steps on the line. Pistons ball. Detroit still has not tasted the lead against Jimmy Rogers' Celtics. Rogers, the Celtic assistant, here in place of Casey Jones, who is attending his mother's funeral. Jones will be back if there is a game seven on Saturday. And Dantley is fouled, and he can give Detroit the lead. Just under 10 minutes remaining in this first half.
Introducing power and price you've never seen in a compact 4x4. The new lower priced Nissan Hardbody V6.
We got the power to make you move. We make it feel like driving.
More horsepower, dollar for dollar, than any leading compact truck. Big and broad, high and wide. There's nothing ordinary about this truck, nothing but the price.
We make it feel like driving, and the name is Nissan.
Come on, everybody, pop, get in. Come on, Jason.
Where am I supposed to sit?
Aren't you glad you used Dial? Don't you wish everybody did?
I need 7 hours of this music.
Seven hours?
Today, you need an insurance company that's sure-footed. A company that looks out for you year after year. A company with experience. You need the Hartford. When you need us most, we're at our best. That's the Hartford difference.
In 1973, a small bar served the first light beer. The response was unanimous.
Tastes great.
Here was a beer with its own special brewing process.
Less filling.
It's brewed from the ground up, not watered down.
Tastes great.
It's less filling.
Today there are lots of lights around, but none are brewed like Miller Lite, and none can match the taste.
Taste great! Less filling! Taste great!
Hey, doll, sounds like our kind of place.
Oh, Mickey!
There's only one light beer, Miller Lite.
He's the legendary Golden Bear, still going strong. Jack Nicklaus hosts the world's best on a course he designed, the Memorial, this weekend on CBS Sports.
Surprise in this series that Larry Bird's carrying the Celtics on his shoulders, although he has not shot the ball that well. He still leads them in those departments, and he's just picked up his second personal foul. And Tommy, while the Celtics have Day and Roberts with three fouls, this man they cannot afford to get into real deep foul trouble.
They do not have as many big people that they can afford anybody to get in foul trouble, the Boston Celtics. The Pistons have five big guys. They've got 30 fouls to waste. Boston's got about 18.
Bird, by the way, the MVP three straight years before Magic Johnson won it this year, sent a telegram to Magic when Irvin won. And, of course, the Lakers are waiting in the wings. They have been off since Monday when they eliminated Seattle in four straight. Pat Riley will be our guest at halftime live. from Los Angeles. And Adrian Dantley with an opportunity, if he makes both free throws, to put the Pistons in front for the first time tonight.
Adrian Dantley, Dick, you've got to maintain a little bit of distance between you and him. Whenever he can feel your body, he uses that feel to spin off. He's got this great spin move. So you got to confuse him a little bit, not let him touch you.
He's a throwback to the days in which 6'3 forwards used to play inside and perform so well. Chuck Daly's Pistons lead for the first time tonight with just under 10 minutes to go in the first half. 16 for Dantley. Posting a bird against Sally. Basket will count and a foul. And as quick as that, the Celtics regain the lead. And Sally has his second foul.
Larry Bird in the low post. That's where he belongs against the smaller people, particularly Adrian Dantley. But he's going to do it against Sally. And Sally, not really an experienced defender down there, isn't used to those kind of moves by Bird.
Rick Mahorn is going to return to the game, and we'll see Sam Vincent and Danny Ainge, a new guard tandem for Boston. 37-35 in favor of the Celtics. Dantley is isolated one-on-one against Bird. Seasting now helps. Johnson hit.
They moved it, but not quite fast enough. They scored, but the rotation was slow, and Boston really even had Vinny Johnson covered on the far side of the court.
Vinny Johnson off the bench is in double figures already. 4 for 6 from the field. Dennis Johnson misses. Long rebound to Sally. And the Pistons will walk it up. Tie score.
And they're matching. Uppercut for uppercut right now.
And Vinny Johnson is fouled. And Larry Bird has picked up his third foul.
There's Larry Bird trying to get at Vinny Johnson. That little pick and roll play worked once again. And Vinny is using it to perfection to get his own shot.
The Celtics have a new backcourt tandem in Danny Ainge and Sam Vincent. There's Ainge. And Sam Vincent, who's a second-year player out of Michigan State, led the Celtics in games 3 and 4 here with 18 points.
Celtics are going to go very small now. They're going with a three-guard offense. DJ will probably end up with Adrian Dantley.
And they use that three-guard offense against the Pistons in game 5.
And they will have to run effectively to score points with this crew on the floor, the Celtics.
39-37, Detroit.
Dantley is not an experienced outside player to defend against the guard out there.
Mahorn is now on Bird, who goes around Mahorn. So Rodman didn't do it, Sally didn't do it, and now Rick Mahorn gets the assignment against Bird.
They would love the Celtics to have Rick Mahorn play Larry Bird. They set it up so he'll have to.
Looping pass to Dantley, loses it out of bounds. Tommy. Jimmy Rogers has elected to keep Bird in the game with 3 personal fouls.
Well, you can't take him out right now. He is going to be the main man on offense for them. They've got to get 40 points from that man.
Sam Vincent misses. Lane Beer with the rebound. 8 minutes to go in the first half. And they'll call the foul against the Celtics. Dantley is fouled.
Bird can't pass right now. There's no double team. So what does he do? He looks Mahorn in the face, gives him an up fake, and it's bye-bye for 2.
Dennis Johnson with his first foul, and Isaiah Thomas comes back in the game. Thomas has scored just 2 points.
But he has not controlled this ball club. They have given the leadership role over to Vinny Johnson, and he's the guy right now that might be able to break this logjam of pace for the Pistons.
And Isaiah Thomas has spent a lot of time on the bench in this half. Mahorn goes strong to the hoop, looking for a foul or a basket, and he got the basket.
They are attacking Larry Bird. Whoever he's guarding is getting the ball.
Bird playing with 3 personal fouls. Going against Mahorn again. McHale setting a screen. And Larry Bird now with 15 points, so he's doing what he can. While he's on the court, We have had now seven ties.
And they're looking to the Bird matchup against Mahorn once again.
And Mahorn beats him again.
Celtics can't afford to trade two.
And a Piston foul will be their fourth team foul of the second period.
As Mahorn down the low post with great position, Bird can't fight him for the low post spot, and Bird just takes his hand away. And here's Bird coming back at Mahorn outside, little up fake behind his back, and Mahorn not quick enough to get to the shooting hand.
Mahorn with his second foul. Ainge goes for three, and here's Thomas.
The man that can blow this game open, particularly on long rebounds off missed shots.
Legends of the NBA. The smooth touch makes it count. Sponsored by Schick. Earl Monroe made the art of razzle-dazzle look as natural as a walk down the street. From spin moves to sweeping baskets, Monroe's complete repertoire flowed with a unique blend of spontaneity and imagination. This style enjoyed universal crowd appeal to the opposition's amazement and made Earl the Pearl basketball's ultimate showman.
Disposable has a new blade angle that's designed to give you a light touch. An easy touch that's closer than ever.
A touch that's easy makes me understand. When it comes to love, I want a slow hand.
The new Schick Disposable for the easy touch.
Detroit has its biggest lead of the game, and right now let's go to Pat O'Brien. Pat.
All right, Dick, thank you very much. You ever wonder who hands out the fines at the NBA? It's Rod Thorne, who's vice president of operations for the NBA. Let's talk about the fines. Are you sent and the suspension? Are you sending a message now to the players with the suspension, Rod?
Well, Pat, I think we're certainly trying to. When you have players of this size and with the leverage generated, you simply cannot allow punching and you cannot allow flagrant fouls. And the commissioner has made many statements over the past several years that we won't allow it.
More fights, more suspensions?
If they continue to fight, then there'll be more suspensions and more fines.
What do you say to the fans? You can't win on this, but what do you say to the fans who said it wasn't enough for Parish?
Well, from our standpoint, we think it definitely was enough to suspend a top-flight player such as Parish, to fine him the amount we did. But we think it was appropriate.
All right, thanks for joining us. Rod Thorne, a man caught in the middle. Let's go back to Dick.
Look at this one. Everything in Boston is just fine, fine, fine. And they listed the fines, of course, in Detroit. Bill Laimbeer was fined $5,000 for his takedown and fight with Larry Bird in game number three. Right here, the Pistons with a four-point lead, and Larry Bird has all three Celtic baskets this period. McHale breaks that string, and the Celtics trail 45-43.
Good penetration that time by Sam Vincent.
Danley is inside again. Ball slapped away by Johnson or McHale, and it's Dennis Johnson out of the pack to Sam Vincent. And one of the guys who can run for the Celtics is Sam Vincent.
He is an excellent push man on the fast break. If Boston can get some people out on the wings, they might be able to score some easy ones.
So the four-point lead for Detroit dissolves. Tie score, McHale gets the rebound. And Vincent slips out of bounds after Thomas had taken the ball away from Sam Vincent, who the two of those work out in the summer in the Michigan area.
Get all over the rebounder. That stops fast breaks. And Isaiah was playing the outlet man, and Sam just slipped on that moisture from the humidity in here, I believe.
5:55 remaining in the first half. The Celtics led by two after one period. Their biggest lead was 10 early in the game. Thomas against Vincent. And Isaiah Thomas, with 6 points now, breaks the tie.
and turning Isaiah loose a little bit. Sam Vincent has played against him in the summer. He may know his moves better than anybody else.
Maybe Magic Johnson knows a few. And Isaiah's hoping that he'll have a date with Magic in a couple of days. Dennis Johnson misses. McHale rebound. And Kevin McHale with 12. And McHale's giving the Celtics some good offensive effort in the first half.
He's doing all he can on the glass, too. Good rebounding both ways.
And he's not 100% suffering from the flu this afternoon. And Laimbeer takes too many steps. Turns it over.
Bird got to him very quickly that time before Laimbeer could rise up for the shot.
Shooting is solid gold by both teams in this game. We have a tie score, and the Celtics playing without Robert Parish, who was suspended, more than holding their own in this first half. Bird, this is a left-hander. Vinnie Johnson. Sally.
That speed on the wing by one of the big guys making it pay off.
Sally and Rodman, they're rookies who have made their mark on the Pistons this year with their young legs. And there's McHale again doing everything for the Celtics. He now has 14 points and has 7 rebounds as well, and several of them off the offensive glass. Game has been tied 10 times in his first half. Winding down to 4 minutes to go. And a kick ball. The Pistons will have a new clock, and Joe Dumars, who's in his second year out of McNeese State and a quiet guard, his tandem with Isaiah Thomas, comes in replacing Vinnie Johnson, who goes out with 12.
And that ought to give the leadership role back to Isaiah Thomas once again. Let's see how well he uses it.
Danley and Johnson have accounted for 28 of the Pistons' 49 points. Laimbeer.
And plays Laimbeer two people away from the double team so that nobody can get to him on the swing, and he's taking the shot free and easy.
And a turnover. Vincent threw it away into the hands of Dumars, and Danley gives the Pistons a 4-point lead, which matches their biggest margin of this first half. A crowd upwards of 30,000 in game 6. The Celtics lead 3-2. The Pistons want to send it to 7.
Cuts through thirst like Gatorade Thirst Quencher. It speeds in fluids and minerals and supplies energy to working muscles.
Quench it! Gatorade is thirsty for that deep down body thirst.
Introducing power and price you've never seen in a compact 4x4. The new lower priced Nissan Hardbody V6. Power dollar for dollar than any leading compact truck. Big and broad, high and wide. There's nothing ordinary about this truck, nothing but the price.
We make it feel like driving, and the name is Nissan.
Al Capone, the king of the underworld.
Somebody messes with me, I'm gonna mess with him.
Elliot Ness, the leader of the Untouchables.
I have sworn to put this man away.
Four honest men took on an army of crime and swore to bring Capone to his knees.
You wait till the fight's over, one guy's left standing, and that's how you know who won.
The Untouchables, rated R. Opens Wednesday, June 3rd at a theater near you.
Coming up soon, and to find out what's in store, let's go up to Pat O'Brien. Pat.
All right, Dick, thank you very much. A primetime edition of the Prudential at the Half tonight. We're going to send you out live to Los Angeles and hear from Pat Riley, who's waiting to find out who he will play in the NBA Finals. A lot of sports news tonight. The Edmonton Oilers going for their third Stanley Cup. And we will have a videotape you'll want to see on repeat champions. Why is it so important or how difficult to repeat? Also today in the first round of the Memorial in Ohio, that's Jack Nicklaus's tournament, Kurt Byram tied a course record. Of course, we'll have live coverage this weekend here on CBS. Back to a guy who's learning to play golf, and he's pretty good, Dick Stockton. Dick.
All right, Pat, thank you very much, and I'll take that with a grain of salt. I am learning. Tommy, would you like to be at a barbecue? Looks like Pat Riley's at a barbecue in California. It looks cool as a cucumber out there.
He's probably burning like the spare ribs out there waiting to get into action. It's tough for a coach to sit out for 4 or 5 days and keep his team's intensity level going.
Jerry Seasting back in the game for the Celtics, teaming up three guards again for Boston with Dennis Johnson and Danny Ainge. Kite and Bird, the other two. Left-handed hook tipped in by Greg Kite after Bird missed.
Any points that Greg Kite scores is a big plus.
Well, Tommy, you talked about the Pistons not pacing the game in the first period. They had only 2 points off the break. They had 8 off the break so far in the second quarter. Dantley against Ainge, tipped up and in by John Sally.
Well, with the three-guard offense, John Sally ends up being blocked out or attempting to be blocked out by Dennis Johnson. He can't get that job done.
We're at the Silver Dome in Pontiac, Michigan. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn. This is game 6 of the Eastern Conference Final. The Celtics are looking to close out the Pistons, who want to send it to a 7th game Sunday in Boston. Seasting misses. And here's Isaiah Thomas in the crowd. Dantley. And Seasting wins the leap for the ball, and the Pistons had a chance to establish their biggest lead, and they couldn't. Dennis Johnson comes back and misses. Dumars now. And it's Pistons ball knocked out of bounds with exactly 2 minutes to go in the first half.
Pistons have to hit the offensive glass, and you watch from the weak side, John Sally right over the top of Dennis Johnson, much too small to try and block out a 7-footer.
Rick Mahorn back in, and Bill Laimbeer goes out. Laimbeer has scored 6 points, came in averaging over 13 in the series. And Fred Roberts, who picked up 3 early fouls, will replace Dennis Johnson, who goes out having missed all 6 of his field goal attempts.
He is showing the real effects of fatigue as far as I'm concerned. His rhythm is all off in his shooting.
Dumars missed. The Celtics trail by 4. 1:45 to go in the first half.
You know, Dick, 1 year when I was a player in the playoffs, I had the flu and all those kinds of things, and my reflexes were so off I couldn't even catch the ball.
Ainge will go to the line. Tommy, sometimes players have a flu and maybe they're a little under the weather, but they end up playing a good game for one game, maybe because of adrenaline.
I think it's adrenaline, and I think the body heat has something to do with it, the rhythm. But boy, the next couple of days, there's a price you pay.
Foul is on Dumars. The Celtics without Robert Parish, and they seem to survive the absence of almost everyone but Robert Parish. They have not won without Parish in the lineup in 2 games.
You know, to see, the Celtics are like the Alamo, Dick. They're putting up a great fight, but the Mexicans are picking them off the walls one by one. And with Parrish's suspension, that's like Santa Ana's boys shot Jim Bowie.
Another history lesson from this guy.
Yeah.
Dumars, top of the key. Mahorn keeps it alive. Dantley is fouled. To the line, a good deal. That's a good sign for the Pistons. Roberts has picked up his 4th personal foul.
And they let Dantley feel a body. They spun him, and they spun him right back into Fred Roberts, but he picked up the foul.
Dennis Rodman, the rookie from Southeast Oklahoma State, replaces Rick Mahorn. And Dennis Johnson quickly comes back in. Vinny Johnson is in the game as well as Dumars goes out.
And Jimmy Rogers has made a decision that Darren Day will not probably play the rest of this half. They're going to use him and his 3 remaining fouls for the second half defense.
Dantley going for his 20th point of the game. And already in this first half has gone to the line 13 times. And that's a good sign for Dantley and the Pistons when he gets fouled that much.
That's one of the things the Pistons did not have with Kelly Chipuka, a guy that could take it to the hoop, get fouled, and rebound as well.
Celtics slowing the pace, trailing by three with a minute to go in the first half. They have nine on the shot clock. Backing in is Dennis Johnson. And he'll go to the line. He has yet to make a field goal, but Dennis Johnson will shoot two. If the Pistons win tonight and take it to a game seven, we will be at Boston Garden Saturday afternoon at 3:30 Eastern time for the deciding game of the Eastern Conference Final. If the Celtics win tonight, the World Championship Series, game one between the Lakers and the Celtics, will start Sunday afternoon, 3:30 Eastern time from the Forum in Inglewood.
32 Kevin McHale.
Kevin McHale comes in for Larry Bird as Dennis Rodman picked up his third foul. So Bird getting a breather.
They do not want Larry Bird to pick up a fourth foul here. And they're willing to come out with less than a 2-point or more than a 2-point disadvantage to Celtics. They're saying we're just happy right now to be where we are.
And he played very well indeed and gave the Celtics some good offensive performance playing with three fouls. Dennis Johnson falls down and Ainge knocked it out of bounds. So there's, Tommy, I think you're right. I think there is, because of the humidity, a film on the floor because several of the Celtics at that side, none of the Pistons, but three Celtics have slipped.
Well, what also happens is that you perspire so much on a humid day. Not that the game of basketball doesn't make you perspire enough, but you just seem to do it more in this type of weather, and that starts dripping all over the floor. You really have to watch yourself.
Thomas from the baseline. And McHale gets the rebound. And a 20-second timeout called by Boston.
20-second timeout.
I would have to say, Dick, that this is absolutely the type of first half that the Celtics would have hoped to have played. Without Robert Parish, the game, even though it looks like it's a pretty high-scoring game, it has not been a fast-paced ball game, except when Boston wanted to make it a fast-paced ball game, when they really rushed it up the court. I think Larry Bird has done a remarkable job of moving people around, and Adrian Dantley has countered him up the other end. Celtics have not found a man to stop Adrian Dantley, nor have the Pistons found a guy to really contain Bird.
Tell me, what about the fact that the Celtics, if they have to battle down on the wire in this game, as opposed to the fact that they were able to rest their starters in games three and four, looking ahead to a Saturday game, does that take more out of them?
Well, the next possible game is a day and a half away. I think that rest will be enough. It wasn't like a Saturday-Sunday event. When they got that blowout on Saturday, Casey Jones yanked everybody early to save it for Sunday.
Six on the shot clock for the Celtics. McHale and Rodman with 9 seconds. Thomas checking the clock. Thomas. And the Pistons by three. And that'll do it for a half. The end of the first half with the score, the Pistons 58, Celtics 55. Pat O'Brien will be back with the Prudential at the half after this message.
Boy, am I drained. I'm almost ready to burn out in this soft white light bulb. But if I were in the Sylvania soft white bulb, I'd last 5% longer. Why, in their 60 watt alone, I'd have 50 more shining hours at no extra cost. So get Sylvania soft white light bulbs and get the most out of me.
Ask for Sylvania, where the best comes to light.
Once upon a time, there was a man named Rumpelstiltskin who could spin straw into gold, which was fine until he decided to travel. Then he discovered the first interstate gold bank card. So Rumpel sold his spinning wheel to Sleeping Beauty's wicked fairy godmother. But that's another story. The First Interstate Gold Bank Card lets you cash a personal check for up to $1,000 in more Citizen states than any other bank system. We help you live happily ever after.
Once and for all, who gives you the best savings in long distance nationwide?
U.S. Sprint, may I help you?
That's right, U.S. Sprint. You can save as much as 10, 20, even 30% versus AT&T on your long-distance calls.
Yes, that's right.
And you'll be signing up with the company that's building the first and only 100% digital fiber optic network clear across America. Now, how do you start getting the best overall savings? Well, you've got to call.
U.S. Sprint, may I help you?
CBS Sports presents The Prudential at the Half. Sponsored by The Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services.
Well, the 30,000 people who have come to the Silver Dome in Pontiac, Michigan are having a good time so far. Their Pistons lead the world champion Celtics 58-55. And good evening, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien. Welcome to a primetime edition of The Prudential at the Half. We've got some basketball news for you, of course. But right now, we hope you're enjoying Game 6 here in the NBA Eastern Conference Finals. There's another Game 6 going on right now in Philadelphia, in the Spectrum, as the Edmonton Oilers are trying to put away the Philadelphia Flyers as the Stanley Cup playoffs continue. Edmonton took an early lead in the game, 1-0, on a shorthanded goal by Kevin Lowe, setting up by Wayne Gretzky. Then the Oilers made it 2-0 as Kevin McClellan stuffed it in. In the second period, the Flyers made it 2-1 on a Lindsey Carson goal, and Edmonton leads the Philadelphia Flyers 2-1. Edmonton would like to go on vacation. How many of you would love to have a week in Southern California away from the office? I guess most of us will. But there is a group of guys out in Los Angeles, a group of laborers, who are kind of anxious about it. The laborers are called the Los Angeles Lakers, and their foreman is Pat Riley, and he joins us live. Thanks for joining us live tonight on At the Half, Pat.
Okay, Pat, how are you?
Fine. We talked yesterday about this rest, and you said you're a little antsy to start playing again.
Well, I think anybody would be. We're not going to use anything as an excuse. We want to get going. I hope that we can play the earliest game on Sunday. That means it would be the Celtics. But the team's working hard. They're in the right frame of mind, and we'll be ready to play.
You mentioned the Celtics. Do you want to play the Celtics? I know you're gearing up for another rematch for that.
We don't care. We want to play the first available opponent on the quickest day. So that would be Sunday. And if Boston gets the job done tonight, that means we start our drive for a championship on Sunday. So we're ready to roll.
In the meantime, you're sort of the psychologist of the team. Has been motivating them all year long, done a great job at it. How do you keep the guys motivated now, Coach?
Well, I think it's important that we work hard. We continue to focus on what we do best. Keep the conditioning at a maximum, and I hope the players, and they're very aware of this, they've been through layoffs before, is that they just try to avoid themselves of all that lifeline to those distractions in Los Angeles that can get them away from the game. So it isn't as much a point as me motivating the group now. They're ready to play, they want to win, and they want to get going.
Pat, we have a piece of videotape I want you to see a little later about repeating. Now, you've been world champions three times as coach. You've tried to repeat and failed. Why is it so tough to repeat these days?
I think what they should do is pass a rule that every team that wins a world championship has the whole next year off, you know, and give them a bye until the playoffs. But it's very difficult. I think you can see that teams that win championships that have to come back the next year, everybody really shoots for them. They're very very competitive games every single night, and you pretty much run out of gas. But winning a championship is durability, and to repeat in that type of marathon, you have to be extraordinary. And I think the Celtics have shown a tremendous resiliency so far this year in trying to defend that title.
All right, Pat, thanks for joining us on a primetime edition of At the Half. We'll see you next week, okay? You know, that is the three-word question all coaches would actually love to answer. Can you repeat? Most say yes, and then they say but. And it's the question marks that have made repeating the record to beat. Last year, the celebrating had just begun. The champagne still had bubbles. And they were already asking, can you repeat?
I was asked that question after the finals against Houston last summer. And that's the first question that came up.
The question has been coming up for 18 seasons since this Boston Celtic team repeated in 1969, and the cold spell has frozen football and baseball as well. Nobody in those sports has repeated in this decade.
The money is not the problem. The issue is the ring. Everybody's patting you on the back. Everybody's building you up more. And then when you come back the attitudes and the enthusiasm starts to change because you say, well, I can do this just as good as this guy. How come I'm not doing it? I want more publicity. I want this. I want that. And then you tend to shy away from the key thing. It's a team.
What happens in a situation where a team has to try and repeat is that once they win the first time, they get drunk on this, the power, you know, of winning, and they fall apart.
Well, not every team falls apart, but many fall down, as night after night they have to dodge speeding bullets.
They go after you more because they want to beat the champions, and besides beating the champions, it's they want to beat the Celtics, and the green is all over the place, and it's like the Yankees of old. Everyone hated the Yankees and wanted the underdog to beat them, and particularly being champions, they're after us.
Everybody seems to be after the New York Mets this year, everybody and everything. There have been so many distractions, you would think the zoo was moved from the Bronx.
Listen, this has been a zoo around here. New York is a zoo playing here. I mean, we've cut videos. We've probably had two or three videos. Everybody's writing a book, and we won 108 games and won the World Series. Didn't bother us. We're kind of used to it, and if it wasn't kind of hectic around here, it wouldn't seem like the ballpark.
You've probably seen it happen over and over. You get on top, and you let up a little. After all, it is nice up there.
You get to a point, you become complacent because you figure, well, nobody could beat us. We're going to win regardless. We're just that good. Then your practice starts to slack off. Then your concentration starts to slack off. And then your interest starts to go in other places because you figure, all I have to do is show up on Sunday to win.
The most recent sports dynasties have been in hockey. The Islanders won 4 straight Stanley Cups. And Edmonton is trying for 3 in 4 years with a cast led by the great Gretzky.
A lot of times the teams who win seem to be content and satisfied with their talent and don't want to make changes because of loyalty, because of championships the year before, and consequently it gets them into trouble. And I think that even if you win, you have to make changes to make yourself a better team.
A better team, that means a core of great players who come back year after year and play hard all the time.
The Big Red Machine, I mean, we had consistent players because we had Hall of Fame players. You're talking about Benches and Perez's and Morgans and Concepcion's and people like that. They were very consistent players over the course of their whole career.
Berg steals it! Johnson!
When all is said and done, this is what legends are made of.
If we get our starting five back, we feel we're going to play a lot of minutes and we're going to be capable of going out and competing against anybody. But there's still a little doubt in our mind that we can go against a Laker team that's 8 or 9 deep.
I conned a half a dozen legends in that piece. When we come back, we'll get you ready for the second half and bring you up to date on the news of the world as At the Half rolls on from Motown Primetime after a word from your local station. Stay with us.
If you can dream it, you can do it. Today, the Prudential can show you a new world of financial opportunities. Look to the rock for mutual funds, stocks, and bonds. Feel its strength in CDs, insurance, and mortgages. With the right choices, the right guidance, the sky's the limit. The Prudential, your rock in financial services.
Friday, 2 special hours of Hard Copy. First, a hostage is taken. Then, can the Post blow the whistle on cops gone bad?
You have nothing.
Hard Copy, Friday.
This is CBS.
They built homes before they were at home and waited for whatever the country might bring. We were here then, and we're here now with new mortgage equity line, a home loan plus a line of credit. Why apply twice when a single application will save you hundreds of dollars? And the paperwork. Wells Fargo Bank, coming through with new mortgage equity line, a home loan plus a line of credit.
Thank you.
When Robin Rogers' decorating business began to outgrow this rather small trailer, she said, now or never, and made a commitment to larger space, more staff, a new phone system, and a very strict budget.
We tailored the Pacific Bell ComStar system to give Robin all of the features that she needed, more than she ever dreamed she could afford. It's easy to use, and it can expand later.
Today, thanks to Pacific Bell, Robin has a phone system that's perfect for her and 304 customers.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's step outside. Okay, now we agree that my Toyota's priced about the same as your Ford Ranger, right?
Right.
And we both have AM/FM cassettes, five-speed sticks, and power brakes, right?
Right.
So what else does your Ranger have for about the same money?
Okay. My Ranger also has power steering, power windows, and door locks.
Really?
Cast aluminum wheels, fuel-injected engine, interval wipers, and halogen headlights.
All that extra on Ranger for about the same money as my Toyota?
Yep.
Still friends?
Well, still brothers.
Get 3.9% financing or $800 cash back on Ford Ranger.
Discover the beauty of Big Bear Friday at 7:30.
And now the weather. It's 85 degrees inside the Silverdome, and the Pistons lead at halftime. We're going to get you ready for the second half, but first let's switch you to New York City for a news update from our studios in New York and CBS News.
Good evening from CBS News. This is Newsbreak. Pentagon officials say the administration has put off its plan to escort Kuwaiti tankers in the Persian Gulf, but the White House says there is no delay. The number two man in Havana's defense ministry flew to Key West, Florida, and defected. U.S. officials call it a major break. Britain's number two diplomat in Iran was kidnapped today. Six armed men dragged him out of his car.
Give me some razz.
Wild over Riuniti Royal Raspberry. The taste of raspberries and natural Riuniti, not a watered-down cooler. And try peach and apple, too.
13-year-old Stephanie Pettit won the 60th annual National Spelling Bee today. Here's how.
S-T-A-P-H-Y-L-O-C-O-C-C-I.
I'm Charlie Rose, CBS News, Washington. More news later on this CBS station.
What's this tough guy?
After aftershave skin conditioner.
I know. I thought I was the only guy with sensitive skin.
Every time I shave, I get it right here.
What do you fellas use? Because shaving irritates my whole face.
After.
Try it.
Looks different.
It's rich.
It's a lotion.
After soothes razor scrape sensitive skin.
Hey, this feels great. And smells good, too. Terrific.
Sensible care for sensitive skin. After aftershave skin conditioner.
By Menon.
Give a little nibble, give a little nibble.
Wendy's asks, before you eat your next hamburger, any hamburger, taste the meat.
Give a little nibble.
Is it dry and chewy, or hot and juicy? Is it bland or is it tasty?
Give a little nibble.
No other hamburger has Wendy's hot and juicy taste. The more you nibble others, the more you'll love Wendy's.
I worked very hard. Let me tell you, I made a lot of sacrifices, you know, trying to be as good as I could be. And I did not want to do anything that was going to short circuit that. Drinking, drugs. It doesn't make sense. I knew that they were counter to what I was working for. It just doesn't make sense.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? The American Express card, don't leave home without it. And by Good News Plus, with a lubricant smooth strip that makes shaving feel so good. Gillette, the essence of shaving.
The Detroit Pistons lead the Boston Celtics 58-55. And Tom, considering the fact that the Celtics are trailing, it's only by 3 points, and playing without Robert Parish, they're playing a tremendous game in light of the fact that their big center is not here today, down by only three.
I think Jim Rogers and Casey Jones out in San Francisco have to be very, very happy with the situation as it is right here at halftime. I would have thought that the Pistons would be able to blow them out in this first half. They haven't done it. In fact, they've shot less shots than Boston. They've only taken 39 shots, the Pistons, to Boston's 44.
Let's take a look at some of the statistics here in this first half, and they're very even, basically. Detroit and Boston both shooting over 50%, although Detroit has the edge. Foul trouble could be a factor as this game wears on, particularly that third man on the Celtic list, Larry Bird, with three fouls. In the first half, Dantley and Johnson accounted for more than half of the 58-point total. Isaiah Thomas came alive a little late, and Bird and McHale led the way. And in fact, if you look at the starting front court, which has been the gauge. The team that has had the most points from the starting front court has won each game. The Celtics, even though they're playing without Parish and Darren Day has not played with the foul trouble, has more points than the starting front court for Detroit.
And you can see with Larry Bird having no assists that his mind is strictly on putting the ball in the hole.
It'll be Celtics with Dennis Johnson and Danny Ainge in the backcourt, Darren Day, Larry Bird, and Kevin McHale up front. Dumars and Isaiah Thomas, Mahorn, Laimbeer, and Dantley for Detroit. McHale, Laimbeer with the rebound. Dantley goes to work and travels before he went up.
Dantley got out on the wing. It looks like the Pistons are coming out of their locker room saying, we're going to run as hard as we possibly can run this half. Off the rebound, the outlet, and up it went quickly.
They had five fewer shots than the Celtics in that first half, and the Celtics are trying to play half court, and Detroit is trying to run. Laimbeer trying to deny McHale. Day slices in and throws up the ball, and out of the pack comes Isaiah Thomas. He's got Dumars and Dantley. And draws the foul, and that'll be four on Larry Bird. Four on Bird early in the third.
Oh, just that kind of up quick pressure creates good things. Bird has to pick him up. And Bird is no match for a swift-footed player like Isaiah. It's not surprising that he'd pick up his fourth personal.
The Pistons are not shooting well at all from the line. They are now 14 of 22 from the free throw line. But the crowd still buzzing over the fourth personal picked up by Larry Bird, the Celtics' leading scorer. And now Thomas misses another. And an offensive foul is called against Bill Laimbeer on top of that. So the Pistons come up empty.
Darren Day is taking some of the pressure off Dennis Johnson having to bring the ball up. Their forwards, the Pistons, not going to go out and press Darren Day.
Double on Bird. Johnson has yet to hit a basket until now.
He has turned down an awful lot of outside shots. I don't think he feels comfortable with that jump shot. Dennis Johnson.
Thomas goes in and it's slammed through by Mahorn. Nearly a steal by Thomas. Again by Dumars, nearly picked it off. And Danny Ainge misses a three. Bird has to be careful inside. He doesn't want to pick up five so soon. Pistons can establish their biggest lead of the game if they can score a basket here. And Bird the rebound.
Dumars up to really take the legs away from Dennis Johnson every time in the backcourt.
It's amazing how these Celtics have hung in there. First against Milwaukee. McHale and Laimbeer is angry and is going to be hit with a technical foul by Joey Crawford. He thought he was pushed by McHale and got hit with a technical.
Here's McHale. Let's see what happens. He's claiming that McHale pushed him. McHale had both hands up in the air. I don't know where the push came from. He tried to give it an acting job, and Joe Crawford said, no, thank you. It's a technical.
Looked like an acting job to me from the angle we saw it.
Face takes enough abuse without your disposable razor hurting it more. Now, Gillette introduces Good News Plus, the new disposable with a white Lubra Smooth Strip designed to reduce pulling and skin irritation.
Hurts so bad.
Finally, there's a disposable that feels so good. Good News Plus, new from Gillette, the essence of shaving.
Here's some great value news from Ford. Right now on Ranger, you can get 3.9% financing or up to $1,000 cash back. Add a special option package and save up to $2,111. Great savings on other Ford trucks, too. See your Ford dealers soon.
California Cooler would like to introduce you to the fundamentals of basketball. Two guards, two forwards, and, of course, the big guy in the middle. California Cooler, the real stuff.
One word distinguishes the American Express card from the others. Member. And membership has its privileges.
We lost our card, our cash.
Even our passport.
You've come to the right place. I can help you.
That's great. That was an easy sale.
No need to wrap it.
I think I can fix it, honey.
That's why I got buyer's insurance.
I left my prescription medicine at home.
Don't worry. Global Assist can help.
To apply by phone, call 1-800-THE-CARD.
He's the legendary Golden Bear, still going strong. Jack Nicklaus hosts the world's best on a course he designed, the Memorial, this weekend on CBS Sports.
Here's the schedule. If the Pistons win tonight, force a game seven, we'll be there at Boston Garden Saturday at 3:30 Eastern time for the deciding game. But if the Celtics come back and win, the 1987 NBA Finals starts Sunday at 3:30 between the Celtics and the Lakers. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn here at the Silver Dome and a big crowd to see whether the Celtics can wrap it up or the Pistons can keep it going. And Tommy, with all the injuries the Celtics have had all year, including the playoffs, maybe more so in the playoffs, they have hung in there in dramatic fashion, beating Milwaukee, coming from behind in the seventh game, and then Bird with the great steal to give them the lead, and it's been a tremendous story, and they've had to do it without Walton.
You know, the most impressive thing to me, Dick, is Boston coming back from those two blowouts. It's like a heavyweight champion going down for 2-9 counts and then coming back and winning the next round.
Well, they've come back to tie this game. 9:40 to go in the third. Lambeer. And the Pistons regain the lead.
And Lambeer really took the shot with Bird rushing at him. So Bird is hanging around Lambeer, and Lambeer did not let that destroy his rhythm.
He only took four shots in the first half. That's low for him. Bird playing with four personal fouls. Day with three. Darren Day connects. Celtics early in the game at a 10-point lead. Pistons came back to tie it. And Detroit led by four in the second half. But it's been a tight, taut game. Mahorn, offensive foul as he ran Danny Ainge into the post.
When you are trying to take the ball to the hoop against a small man, he'll use his feet faster than you can. What you should do against a small man in a low post is turn up, face, and shoot the ball. He can't get at it.
And of the bench scoring, 12 for Detroit came from the hands of Vinny Johnson. Mahorn now with three fouls, so he and Rodman with three fouls for the Pistons. 10 on the clock. Four on the clock. And Ainge out of bounds. And the 24-second clock. The basket is good.
It hit the rim, and the official said it hit the rim, and he waved off the clock.
Ainge managed to hit the rim, starting a new clock, and then Darren Day laid it in, even though the buzzer sounded. It should not have sounded. And Thomas gets the basket and the foul. Isaiah Thomas. Thomas and Lambeer have scored just 18 points between them. And we're tied again at 64, and Isaiah Thomas can untie it. Foul is on Ainge, his second. Here is the ball that hit the rim, creating in the new clock.
Well, Ainge takes a desperation shot, and you see it just nicked the rim, and Darren Day was right there.
This is a well-officiated game, Tommy.
This is the best officiated game of the series so far that I can see. The fouls have been evenly distributed, and the ticky-tacky stuff is not being called, only legitimate hard foul.
Larry Bird with 18, leading Boston. And the Celtics lead by one. Thomas. Danley comes back and gives Detroit the margin of one. 21 in the game.
When you push the ball hard at the defense and then you take a shot, it does set up good offensive rebounding because the people are more concentrating on the penetration than blocking out for the boards.
Bird gives the Celtics the lead, and back and forth they go. And right now it's Bird and Thomas in a shootout with 7:25 remaining in the third. for the Pistons. Thomas didn't score, so the two forwards continue to go at it. And the sparring here in the third period at the Silver Dome. Day nearly lost his footing. Lambeer closes in on McHale. Six on the shot clock. And another rebound for Lambeer.
The big plus, Mahorn running up. Parish, McHale rather, and Bird getting a little tired, getting back.
And it's still Boston ball. It was off the leg of a Piston. But the pressure offense by the Pistons seems to be taking its toll right now. We'll be back with 6:34 remaining.
Pardon me, folks. How do you like your new Ford Aerostar?
Oh, it's great.
Think you can tell me about it in less than 30 seconds?
Well, it does so many things. We take the kids to school.
We go to the drive-in movie.
We tow the boat.
And the dirt bikes.
We brought the new table home.
Helped your sister move.
Took my French club to the airport. Sometimes we sleep in it.
I drove it to the prom.
The kids listen to their music in it.
I can carry the fellas to the golf course.
We took
Sorry, you're out of time.
I didn't get a tour.
Ford Aerostar.
I've been doing a lot of thinking lately about Miller Lite. What a profound concept. It's got a third less calories than I probably thought it didn't even have. And it's less filling than it would have been if it was more filling than they didn't want it to be. Plus, it tastes as great as you expect, if it had more calories than it didn't have in the first place. Think about that.
In other words, there's only one light beer, because if there wasn't, he wouldn't be saying there is. Right, yo?
If you ever wasted a Saturday trying to replace a cheap tension spring or a sheared pin, this needs to be your new mower. If you ever killed a Sunday by chewing up a drive belt or burning out a bearing, this needs to be your new mower. This is a John Deere, and because it's built so well, you can get something from a John Deere that you can't always depend on with other mowers. You can get done.
Said at the top of the game that Larry Bird's steal to win game five goes into history with other great steals by the Celtics.
Greer is putting the ball on a play. He gets it out deep, and Havlicek steals it over the statue. Havlicek stole the ball. It's all over. It's all over.
Worthy will inbound to Magic Johnson. Worst comes to worst, the Celtics will have to foul. And there's a steal by Henderson, who lays it up and in.
Steal by Bird. Underneath the DJ, lays it in. Right at 1 second left. What a play by Bird. Oh, my, this place has gone crazy.
And all those words and those sounds came from that man, Johnny Most, who's no favorite here in Detroit, but they love him in Boston. And, of course, he's no favorite of Bill Laimbeer's and vice versa.
You know how he prepares for a game, Johnny Most?
How?
He gargles with Santa Flush.
Sounds it. Less than 6.5 remaining in the third. It's 71-68 in favor of Detroit. The Celtics hang in there. And Larry Bird brings them to within one. And the Celtics playing without Robert Parish, a big factor.
And they like the Celtics, the Mahorn matchup on Bird.
Tommy, you said Bird has to have a good shooting night. He's 9-13. He's doing it. Inside to Dantley. No foul was called. And now the Celtics come back with 6 minutes to go in the third. McHale. And now Thomas pushes it up. Dumars. He'll go to the line and shoot two. We started the game without Parish here for Boston and without Casey Jones. You're looking at Jimmy Rogers, who has been a respected assistant coach under Casey Jones and Bill Fitch, the predecessor. Good basketball mind. And Casey Jones is back in San Francisco attending tomorrow's funeral of his mother, Eula Jones, who passed away. And again, we send our sympathies and condolences to Casey as Jimmy handles the club tonight.
You know, Jimmy and Casey were assistants for Bill Fitch, as you said. But Casey felt that he didn't have any input with Bill Fitch, and he vowed when he became a head coach once again that his assistants would really get a role in the set.
The lead is three by the Pistons. Danley picks up Ainge in the crowd with Mahorn. Dennis Johnson goes for three. He's off the mark, but Bird gets a big offensive rebound and makes a tough basket off the glass. So Bird is 10 for 14 from the field, and the Celtics hang in there trailing by one. Lambeer misses. Day the rebound, and Boston can regain the lead. And an offensive foul against Danny Ainge. Good position by Lambeer on that play.
Absolutely good position. Danny Ainge should have tricky dribbled and then taken it across from Lambeer. And Lambeer just steps out, spreads out wide, and Ainge creates the contact.
Third foul on Ainge. The lead is one for the Pistons. If they don't win this game, their season is over. Danley loses it, and a two-on-one for Boston. And the Celtics lead by one.
They're going to Adrian Dantley's well much too often. The Celtics defense, DJ is moving him around a little bit, and the other Celtics are helping better.
Dumars off the glass.
Joe Dumars.
Big hoop by Joe Dumars. You know, and he's produced all those kind of key shots.
And a steal by Dumars. And Ainge and Dumars are separated by Joey Crawford. And Ainge was kind of saying to Dumars, come on, take a shot at me.
It was a bad pass by Danny Ainge. He just lost the ball. And here's Dumars picks it up and heads, and Danny Ainge tries to go after the ball and stop the layup.
The fourth foul against Danny Ainge, who tried to get Dumars into something and do a scrap. Dumars wisely did not. Ainge leaves the game with four, and Seasting replaces him.
Here's Danny Ainge, steal of Dantley. DJ really does not let Dantley feel him too much, and Danny Ainge right down there with his quick hands, and look how easily Boston can convert steals themselves.
I credit Dumars for having the cool head and not taking that challenge where he might have been thrown out.
I think Joe Dumars is an exceptionally fine basketball player who has fit in behind Isaiah Thomas and Vinnie Johnson and still gets the job done.
John Sally, the seven-footer, adds some fresh legs to the Piston attack as Mahorn goes out of the game. Mahorn has 11 points. More important, he has grabbed 8 rebounds.
Jimmy Rogers is just doing a fantastic job for the Celtics tonight, rotating his people through the lineup.
He's in way too early.
77-74, Detroit. 4:25 in the third. Looking for McHale. Seasting recovers. And Darren Day hits another big shot here in this period. Day has 14 points, 8 of them here in this third period.
I think they're taking him for granted, the Pistons. He can score.
7 of 9 from the field. Thomas. 13 for Isaiah Thomas.
Good pass back by Dantley. He did not force the play.
Vinnie Johnson gets his warm-up suit off. Lambeer on Bird. Sally on McHale. And illegal defense is called against the Pistons. And that'll be a technical foul. Second time that Detroit has been guilty.
Joe Dumars crossed that middle line, that imaginary middle line that runs down the foul lane. And once you do that, you must go double the ball. And he didn't do that.
Tommy, Chuck Daly going heavily into his bench now. He's brought in Vinnie Johnson, Sally, and Rodman. And it looks like against the likes of McHale and Bird, he wants to make a big push here.
He has been trying to design a torture test for the five Celtic players, only Jimmy Rogers is using more players and more frequently, perhaps, than Casey Jones does, so the torture test may not work.
McHale hangs in there with the Celtics, and Kevin with 18 points. Bird has scored 25. And maybe on the way to the 40 that you thought he would need today for the Celtics to make up for the loss of Parish. Thomas for two. And he looks like he's got the long range marksmanship going now.
Well, Seasting will have to go out and get him. And once he does that, Isaiah can blow right by him.
No more than 4 points have separated the two teams since the middle of the first period. It's been that kind of a battle. With 2:35 to go in the third. Thomas gone for three in a row. McHale clears. And the Celtics can tie it here. Larry Bird now with 27 points. He had a series high of 36 in game five, along with that great steal. And Bird with another big scoring game. Thomas. He still has it. And the Pistons are up again.
Isaiah just blew by Seasting that time, went to the left hand, couldn't hit it, having trouble with his left hand tonight, but came back and got the rebound. Big play.
From the start to this point, this is the best game of the series. Day goes up. Lambeer rebound. Here comes Vinny Johnson to Rodman. And Dennis Johnson breaks it up.
What a great defensive play by DJ. There was a 4-on-3.
Day hits the basket. So Dennis Johnson made it happen. And the Celtics come back to tie. And a 20-second timeout called by Chuck Daly.
Here's the great play by Dennis Johnson. He knows that the trail is coming up. And he just gets in there after the pass and creates an opportunity to make the steal. Bird has been playing in and out basketball. When he feels he's got a guy he can work on in the low post, he takes it to him. Beautiful left-hand shot by Bird. And here's a great effort by Isaiah. Seasting forces him to the left hand. Can't make it, but look at him come back and go high for the rebound and then stick it back in.
In golf, where perception can turn a small stand of trees into a forest of sequoias, Top Flight XL delivers the confidence, the extra distance, and the higher trajectory to let you cut the corner and turn obstacles into opportunities. Only Top Flights are the longest balls.
Today you need an insurance company that looks out for you, with experience you can count on, and a firm financial footing. You need the Hartford. When you need us most, we're at our best. That's the Hartford difference.
Here's great value news from Ford. Now Tempo is available with 3.9% financing or $600 cash back. Add a special option package and save up to $1,558. Great savings available on other Ford cars, too. See your Ford dealer soon.
They call for it on the Marienplatz in Munich. They call for it in the Canadian Rockies. And they call for it in Newport Beach, California. Lowenbrau, brewed around the world. Taste it and you'll know why. Rich Bavarian house and supervision, brewed fresh and smooth in America. It's the best way in the world to brew beer.
This world calls for Lowenbrau right now.
All right, right now let's go to Pat O'Brien, Pat.
All right, Dick, you know, every mother in the country, I think, feels badly when her son is maligned and feels good when her son is praised. This is Joan Lambeer, Bill Lambeer's mother. How have you been holding up this week with all the publicity?
Oh, it's tough, I'll tell you. It really is. I'm a wreck.
What kind of a guy is Bill from a mother's standpoint?
He's a great guy, a great son, a great father, a great husband, everything.
You called him a gentle giant in the newspaper. Is that true?
Exactly.
She's very into this game. We're going to let her get back to it. Who's going to win tonight?
Thank you. I hope, Pistons. I hope. Hang in there, guys.
All right, Mrs. Lambert, let's go back to Dick.
Thank you, Pat. You know, until his last contract, he was one of the few NBA players whose dad made more money than he did. He's a big corporation executive. You don't often find that in this league, right? Now I think Bill makes more than his dad. And a foul away from the ball against the Celtics.
Boston foul with 50.
Celtics are into the penalty. The Pistons have committed only one team foul as the temperature and humidity continue to be hot and humid.
I would have expected the Pistons to be a lot more aggressive defensively with all the people they can afford to play, and they only have one team foul here in this quarter.
The foul was on Kite, his third. And Detroit not having a good game from the line. They are now 20 of 30. They have missed 10 free throws. We have under a minute to go, and the Pistons, with a one-point lead, they've gone back and forth in the later stages of this third period. Dennis Johnson, only 1 of 10 from the field, but he has 10 assists and 2 steals. Bird finds Dennis Johnson. Still having problems shooting. Sally the rebound. Feasting all over Thomas. Vinny Johnson. And Kite with 20 seconds, and the Celtics can play to take the lead to wrap up the third here. Celtics led by 2 after one period, and the Pistons were 3-point leaders at the half.
This has been a fantastic basketball game.
Sally commits the foul, and that's the first in the last 2 minutes. The next one will result in a shooting situation as the Pistons will call a timeout here with 8 seconds remaining. Well, the Pistons are trying to survive where they have won 10 in a row at home and 6 straight in the playoffs. And if they do, they'll have to go to Boston Garden, where they have not won in 5 years and have dropped 17 straight. It'll be the Pistons-Celtics if Detroit wins this game. If not, Sunday will start the NBA Finals between the Lakers and the Celtics. And, of course, both days this weekend will have the Memorial. And, Tommy, once again, the Boston Celtics, who a lot of people thought after the 2 blowouts in Game 3 and 4 might find the same fate, are hanging with the Pistons, who are going to need the big fourth quarter period effort to send us to a 7th game.
Well, I thought the Pistons found the way to beat Boston, which was to upbeat the game, put the ball in Isaiah's hands and let him control the pace of the game. And they got out to good first quarters in those 2 games here. They did not tonight. It was not paced in a fashion that the Pistons could blow the Celtics out.
You said at the top that if the Pistons get a little comfortable with Parish not in there, they could find themselves in trouble. I don't detect the fact that the Pistons felt that way, but whatever has happened, the Celtics seem to have risen their play without Parish tonight.
I think they're more concerned, Dick, in trying to emotionally control Isaiah Thomas than beating the Boston Celtics. That's my opinion. He has not handled the ball an awful lot. They have let other ball players control his ball club and run the ball club, when this, to me, clearly calls for Isaiah to push it hard at the defense all the time.
Those are the numbers we just told you about. We have 8 seconds to go. Dennis Johnson will get it done in other ways, like Larry Bird will get it done in other ways when he's not shooting well.
Dennis's rhythm is really off in his shooting, and he's very reluctant to take the outside shot, but he's taking him now because he has to show the team that he's willing to take the outside shot.
3 seconds to go. Ainge will try to give the Celtics the lead, and he can't. But it's close. That's the end of the third period with the score. Detroit 84 and Boston 83. And we'll return to the Silver Dome after this word from your local station.
Saturday, they took... Introducing a Coors like you never knew before. New Coors Extra Gold.
This ain't no quiche, eater, soda, pop, beer, you'll agree. Cause no beer's as bold.
Coors could make it so easy drinking.
Yeah, this is Boulder Kohler beer, the way beer ought to be. One taste you'll be sold, grab hold of a gold. No beer's as bold as Coors Extra Gold.
It's not Jamaica. It's not Tahiti. Certainly not Mazatlan. It's Las Vegas, man. Only at the Tropicana. Come play on the island.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Miller High Life. Miller made the American way since 1855. Renault and Jeep, official vehicles of the NBA. And by Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services.
And welcome back to the Motor City. We're in Pontiac, a suburb of Detroit, where the Boston Celtics getting the front court scoring edge, and that's been the barometer that has decided every game. Even though Robert Parish isn't here tonight and Darren Day starting instead, the Celtics dominating the front court scoring. It's an 84-83 game, the Pistons lead, but when you're playing without your top center, down by one, going to the final 12 minutes with a chance to close it up, you're not in bad shape.
Setting picks, huh? Watch what happens underneath. Now Sally turns into the perfect gentleman, holds Seasting from falling heavy to the ground, and you're going to see what's going to happen as they come. Well, after he came out of the, they call a timeout. Chuck Daly was furious at Sally for catching Seasting. Let him fall, he said.
Well, Sally's a nice guy, I think. He's Vinnie Johnson. 14 off the bench, and he's averaged 18 in the series.
They need a hot hand right now, and Danley is on the bench. They've got some speed in there too to capitalize on, but McHale is on the bench.
Sally and Rodman with Isaiah Thomas and Vinnie Johnson. Ainge with 3 seconds on the clock. Rodman the rebound.
Ainge has not hit that outside shot.
He did early. The biggest lead of the game right now for Detroit in a timeout, Boston.
Soar beyond your expectations. Today, the Prudential can show you a new world of financial opportunities. Look to the rock for stocks and bonds, mutual funds. Feel its strength in CDs, insurance, and mortgages. With the right choices, the right guidance, you can move mountains. The Prudential. Your rock in financial services.
Jeep Cherokee has just been reborn. It can now be ordered with a 4-liter, 6-cylinder, 173-horsepower engine. Nothing in Cherokee's class even comes close. In fact, with this engine and a choice of 2 or 4 doors and 2 shift-on-the-fly 4-wheel drive systems, you could say nothing's in Cherokee's class.
Now get 3.9 financing or up to $600 cash back on select Jeep Cherokees.
America's game. It's fantastic.
Welcome back to game 6 of the Eastern Conference Final in the NBA. The Detroit Pistons with their biggest lead here at the Pontiac Silverdome tonight. 5 points, looking to tie the series and send it to a 7th game. The young legs have done it. Rodman and Sally setting the pace, and tonight 28,383. They went over a million this year for the regular season and postseason.
Now is the time, Dick, to push the ball hard at the Boston Celtics, because if they're tired, now's the time it will show.
All but two of the Celtics' points this half have come from their front court. Mahorn on Bird. They isolate Bird one-on-one with Mahorn. 5 points is the biggest lead in the game for either team since midway in the first period.
And Danny Ainge is successfully denying Isaiah the opportunity to handle the ball.
Little more than a minute and a half gone by in this fourth period. Thomas and Dennis Johnson. The rebound.
Well, he's doing it all except scoring. Dennis Johnson. Rebounds.
Assists. Ainge has struggled. He's missed his last seven after a red hot start. Day.
They need some offensive rebounds right now. Boston on those missed shots. They're flat footed.
Isaiah Thomas just asked Ed Rush something as the Pistons brought it up. Vinny Johnson. For Vinny Johnson. Biggest lead of the game for the Pistons, and the crowd on its feet. Sally all over Bird. And another rebound by Mahorn.
Giving that extra effort makes winners. The All You Can Be, sponsored by the U.S. Army. No box score can ever reflect the true value of defense. Despite merits like block shots and steals, a solid defense is determined by what hasn't been done. It's a discipline that frustrates an opponent's intentions and eventually bends his will. By mastering the art of denial, Michael Cooper has made himself the best he can be.
Landing zone. Prepare to land.
Let's move! We got a connection to make.
Give the Army Signal Corps 30 minutes and they can turn a mountaintop into a satellite communication station. Qualify for training like this and you'll learn to work with some of the most exciting high-tech electronics around.
Roger, Bravo 2-6. Loud and clear.
We got him!
Right. All that you can
did well. We're well connected, Sergeant.
Find your future in the Army.
Dennis Rodman over here pays off, and John Sally also getting into it as Isaiah makes the hard push to the middle. There's only one, two, three Celtic defenders, and Isaiah reads it perfectly. Up they come. Isaiah looks and just finds Rodman perfectly, and that's the way to make it happen against the tired ball club. Throw speed against it.
Here it is from another angle, and Rodman celebrating as he does. Fists in the air. The Celtics have not scored in exactly 4 minutes. They were tied at 83 just before the end of the third. The Pistons have scored 9 in a row and can get more.
And this is what has happened to the Celtics historically. They have cooled off in the fourth quarter. As they've gotten tired, their outside shooting evaporates.
That happened in game five before the miracle play saved them. Thomas to Johnson.
Isaiah is controlling the game, Dick. Doing the job that I thought he could do.
11 in a row for Detroit. Dennis Johnson. And a block. And they call goaltending. Against Mahorn, and credit Dennis Johnson with the hoop.
I don't think it was goaltending unless it hit the glass before Mahorn touched it. It looked like the ball wasn't anywhere near the top. Looked like it's good play.
The Pistons have scored 11 in a row, and Sally hangs on to it. We have 8:10 remaining in the fourth period. Pistons threatening to break it wide open. Mahorn saves it. And the Pistons are out jumping the Celtics inside. And a foul. Vinnie Johnson will go to the line. Dennis Johnson with the foul.
Well, the fresh legs of Rodman, the springing legs of Rodman and Sally paying off here right now on the boards, too. And the wide body of Ricky Mahorn clearing people out for Rodman to jump. Allow Rodman and Sally to jump over the tired Celtics.
What a fortunate happenstance for the Pistons, Tommy, who have not always had the right personnel. Keep in mind, they traded Livingston and Carr to Atlanta for a round field. They ended up with Mahorn to get two outstanding rookies who jump so well and who are so active as Rodman and Sally.
And they're only going to get better as they pick up that experience. And I think Rodman defensively has already showed, as the series has progressed, that he might be able to handle Bird a little bit better as each game goes by. And Sally has showed me something defensively.
We had a problem with the clock. Presumably it's been corrected. And Vinnie Johnson, who has hit 7 of 11 from the field, on the line.
And they've done this with Adrian Dantley on the bench.
Dantley scored 23 points.
Good usage of speed right now by Chuck Daly at just the right time with the accelerating unit.
It's a 13-2 run for the Pistons. And Dennis Johnson going strong to the basket. Nearly 4 minutes gone by here in the fourth period. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn at the Silverdome. Rodman quick to the hoop.
And Isaiah is picking out the good places to go if he doesn't take the shot himself.
And a Piston foul. Against Isaiah Thomas, his third foul. And team fouls are 1-1 here in the fourth period. Pistons win. We go to a game 7 Saturday at Boston Garden. Sam Vincent. Oh. And here's Thomas.
Mistake by the Celtics. Nobody covered the backcourt after Vincent penetrated.
And the Pistons very much in control here. And Bird, Dennis Johnson, and McHale playing a lot of minutes on a humid night for game 6. DJ misses, and Sam Vincent called for the foul on Rodman. Tommy, game 7 would be Saturday. That's a day and a half from now, and the Celtic veterans have played a lot today in humid weather against Detroit. No concession as we had in game 3 and 4 when they benched the starters early.
Well, they've had certainly a lot of rotation substitutions to pattern. I don't think they're as tired as in this one as they were in the other ones.
Sally and Bird with a great block inside. And he'll call Thomas with his fourth foul. This this was the sign in the Pistons locker room. They anticipated the humidity tonight.
Celtics do not have their regular low post game to go to. Robert Parish is very definitely a prime player in the fourth quarter. They used him a lot against the matchup of Lambeer or Mahorn to score.
The Pistons commit a foul. Kevin McHale limping here. Keep in mind, he's playing with a stress fracture plus an ankle sprain, and it's just amazing that he's been out there at all for these playoff games.
Kevin McHale, it's really hurt his game, too, not being able to plant his feet because he's been getting moved out of that low post position by Mahorn a lot.
Day misses. And Rodman and Mahorn get the ball. Rodman committed his fourth foul. And in his fourth period, Detroit has outscored Boston 16-4 with 6:23 remaining.
That's what this Pistons team is capable of, though. Big explosions.
22 for Vinnie Johnson, 10 here in the fourth. He's exploded in the final period. And Sam Vincent is fouled. That's the 15th foul against the Pistons. Let's check. Just the fourth. The next foul will put them in the penalty. And Vinnie Johnson with his first foul.
Well, fast break explosions took the game out of Boston's reach, I think, at this point. They can't peck away. They're going to have to run to try and get back into it and hit some three-pointers.
Bird hit a shot reminiscent of Don Nelson's big basket in the 69 championship. Remember that one?
Skyball that hit the back of the rim and almost hit the rafters. And went in. Two.
And a big basket at the time. 5.5 to play. Vinnie Johnson, not that time. 102-89 in favor of Detroit. They've exploded here in the fourth period. And now the Celtics will shoot two as Bird is fouled by John Sally, who picks up his fourth foul.
Here's Bird's Don Nelson shot. He's really been short an awful lot in this series. It hit the back of the rim and went straight up in the air for almost a two count before it came back down.
Here's Lambeer, and Sally goes out to this hand.
Just Sally's running ability is so important. It puts pressure on the Celtic defense that Lambeer and Mahorn can't do.
And he makes the Pistons an exciting team to watch, and they weren't always that way.
It's quite a duo to come off the bench, the Pistons having Rodman and Sally.
Meanwhile, Larry Bird has checked in with 31. And the lead is 11, and still plenty of time to go. Danny Ainge back in the game, and he's the Celtics' best three-point shooter in case.
They've got to get it down to under 10 with 3 minutes.
Rodman got a good shot there.
The only low post option right now is Kevin McHale to go to. And the Celtics are having difficulty trying to do it. Just get him the ball.
Dennis Johnson kicks it away, and Bird gets a basket out of it. I don't think that was on the blackboard before they started. Again, it's 11 with 4:35 to go.
Pistons have been very effective with their defense in the half-court game of the Celtics at times by pushing the Celtics' low-post people up the lane so the double teams can be much quicker and easier.
Mahorn, 14 points. The heat is on. That's the best sign I've seen all night.
You know, I always wondered, why does Miller High Life come in a clear bottle? Boy, did I ever find out.
It shows the quality and the purity in our beer.
It's a natural process. No shortcuts. We don't cut corners.
One reason for the clear bottle was to show purity, but there was another one, too.
This is dark roasted barley malt.
I found out that roasted malt makes Miller darker.
You really can see the difference.
It makes a lot of sense. When you make a beer that looks dark and rich, you put it in a clear bottle so everyone can see it. Now, in my book, that's the American way.
Can go.
where perception can turn placid fogs into oceans of trouble. Top Flight Plus delivers the extra distance that turns obstacles into opportunities. Only Top Flights are the longest balls.
The Great American Face. Rugged. Distinctive. The Great American Razor. Actra. Solid. Pivots for closeness. The Great American Face deserves the Great American Shave. Actra. Only from Gillette.
You do not have to visit our Hawaii office.
They need my expertise, my marketing magic.
We can send your expertise without sending you. Our new IBM Personal System 2 connects with all our other computers to send reports and plans.
Yes, but I want to dangle my toes in the surf.
Dangle your fingers right here. Everything's connected. Aloha.
Aloha. Where do you want these?
Hey, ask him. He's the one going to Hawaii.
Introducing the new Personal System 2 from IBM.
And Saturday, the PGA Tour on CBS Sports continues when Jack Nicklaus plays host to the world's best golfers on a course he designed, the Muirfield Village Golf Course in Dublin, Ohio. It's the Memorial Tournament. Check your local listings for the time in your area Saturday on CBS Sports. If the Pistons hold their lead, we'll be in Boston Garden 3:30 Saturday for the deciding game of this Eastern Conference thrilling series. And here's that play, not on the blackboard, but it scored two for the Celtics.
Accidental offense, but Bird, alert to accidents, turns it into two, and that's how quickly he thinks and is so alert.
The Celtics have Sam Vincent and Dennis Johnson, along with Ainge. They're going with three guards a lot tonight, and McHale and Bird up front.
Well, that's in an effort to counter the speed of the Pistons right now.
For three, hits one, and Danny Ainge.
Now, as 4 minutes tick and it's down to 10 points, the Celtics would hope to have it under 10 by 3 minutes.
Ainge has hit 5 of 12 three-point attempts in this series, and they have 3:48 to go. It's a lot of time, and Vinny Johnson tips in his own miss, make it Dumars with the tip in.
What a play by Vinny Johnson. I think it was him.
They gave it to Dumars.
With Vinny Johnson, in my opinion.
Slapped away into the hands of Mahorn, and here's Dumars, and it's out of bounds. Second and 10.
Vinny on the glass. Has no fear whatsoever. Just goes back and tipped it in. Yeah, it was Vinny Johnson, not Joe Dumars.
They gave it to Dumars, but I agree with you.
Dumars was still on the floor when the ball.
Well, he leaped too. He was right to the right of the shot.
You're going to argue with me now?
Well, I'll see it again. I won't argue with you. You've been in the game too long.
And Isaiah is not out there running the show, nor is Adrian Dantley. What Chuck Daly has on the court right now is what he feels might be his best defensive unit.
Danny Ainge penetrating to McHale. And it's 108-98, a 10-point lead with 3:21 to go. The Celtics have been living with their front court scoring. The back court is having an horrendous shooting night. Winding down to 3 minutes, Dumars in trouble. 8 on the shot clock. Here's Lane Beer.
Big basket. The Pistons worked the clock down effectively and still came up with a good-looking shot.
Ainge for three again. And Rodman the rebound. And Bird steals the ball. And McHale gets the basket. And the basket counts and a foul. And Larry Bird made another incredible play.
You just cannot stop thinking when you play against the Celtics. Now here's Rodman. And you watch Bird just slip around from the blind side. Tip it to McHale. And Rodman came up underneath McHale. So he'll get the foul shot to boot. Now you watch Dennis Johnson knowing what Bird does in key spots. We're on our way, he's saying.
Dennis Rodman with his fifth personal foul. One more and he's out. And the three-point play cuts the Piston lead to 9. They were up by 15 not so long ago. 2:40 remaining in the fourth, and the Celtics making a run. Tightening the defense. And a palming violation against Vinny Johnson turns it over to the Celtics.
Big turnover, Dick. Vinny Johnson now trying to be the floor general of this team. Isaiah's still on the bench. He's got great one-on-one ability, Vinny Johnson.
9-point lead for Detroit, 2:15 on the clock. And a steal. Lambeer knocked it away. Big steal for Detroit. And Chuck Daly wants a timeout.
Detroit calls timeout.
9-point Piston lead, 2:06 on the clock. We'll be back to the Silver Dome for the finish.
This is something new for us, something bigger. It's called Medallion. When you compare its passenger and cargo room to the competition, a lot of that competition falls away. Compare horsepower, a lot more disappear. And when you consider that Medallion comes with a 6-year, 60,000-mile warranty, you just might end up right here.
Now, limited time offer on Medallion, 3.9% factory financing.
No cheap performers.
Life is full of changes, and State Farm is there.
I'm State Farm agent George Palmy. If your family's like mine, you'll find reminders of how fast things change. Wasn't so long ago, my daughter Jill was riding in this. Now she drives this. Look around you. If you see your insurance needs have changed, auto, home, life, or health, see your State Farm agent for a family insurance checkup. The advice is free.
And like a good neighbor.
And the decisions are yours.
State Farm is there.
Ah, I feel good.
Time to go, boys. You've been in there long enough.
Hey.
Though I've checked the mileage and
hey, we're the auto lights. We're guaranteed.
Guaranteed?
I feel good. Yeah, 2 years no matter how far we go.
But no spark plug guarantees that.
We do.
So good.
Yeah, we're the auto lights.
But I...
So go pull the plug on somebody else.
Okay.
Feel good.
The finals on CBS Sports. We will rock you.
A possible seventh game. What are the travel plans? How do things look?
All right, Dick, you know how much you hate red eyes? Boston is taking a 2 o'clock in the morning plane. They get into Logan in Boston at 4 in the morning. Detroit's going to get a good night's rest. They're leaving at 12:55 tomorrow afternoon. Let's talk about game sevens for a moment while they party here in the Silver Dome. 15-3, that's Boston's record in game sevens. At home, they're 12-2 in game sevens. Detroit has only played one game seven in the franchise's history. They lost to the Chicago Bulls. There's your travel, there's your game sevens. Dick, I'll see you on the airplane.
All right, Pat. And at the conclusion of the game, Tom and I will select the Miller Lite player of the game. In conjunction with the award, Miller Lite will present a check in the amount of $1,000 to the National Multiple Sclerosis Society in that player's name. 2 minutes to go.
Isaiah and Adrian Dantley both back in the game.
Lambeer, he's been hitting big baskets here in the fourth period when the fast break has slowed down to a walk.
And Chuck Daly wants his real offensive people in right now to control the clock.
And Sam Vincent scores. Now the Celtics have committed just 2 team fouls, but they'll lose one of those fouls to give under the 2 minutes. So the second foul under 2 minutes is a shooting situation.
Pistons have to take as much of the 24-second clock off as they can and still come up with
Dennis
a good
Jackson
shot.
Jackson knocks the ball away into the hands of Bird. It's 9. It could be 7 or less. Ainge for 3. And that would have been a big one for the Celtics had Ainge hit it. And now Isaiah Thomas in no hurry.
Dick, right now the ball game is in Isaiah's hands. Look at the clock. Create something good down around the 8-second mark.
Thomas. This is the layup. He had a good shot. And now the Celtics with a minute to go. Bird. And Larry Bird with 35 in the game. And it's 112-105.
They just never quit the Boston Celtics. They play it for the full 48.
But all the Pistons need is to hold on to force a one-game series. And a foul against Sam Vincent, and that is the one foul the Celtics can give under the two-minute situation. The next foul by Boston will result in 2 shots as we look at the facts remaining. Celtics have no more timeouts. They have a 20, that's all. 8 on the clock. Dantley and Mahorn misses. Dantley again. Foul. And Dantley is gone after Danny Ainge and has to be held off. Remaining in the game, and Dantley will shoot two with a 7-point Piston lead, and Chuck Daly is out there to calm him down.
Well, you know something, Dick, they got the rebound, they missed the layup. Dantley got the second rebound. He should have taken it out and worked the clock down. Now here's the good shot off the rebound, and Dantley comes in, he's in traffic. He should have just taken it out and not forced the shot. He ends up with two, but they would have been better served with another 24 seconds. And here's Mahorn, Smiley, Rick Mahorn, the peacemaker. That's a new role.
The foul was on Dennis Johnson. Larry Bird, 35 points. He delivered tonight in a big way. But Adrian Dantley now with 24 to lead the Pistons, and 10 of 14 from the line. And most of those in the first half. Makes only one. And it's 113 to 105. Time running out. Dantley the rebound. And a foul. The Pistons are going to send this to a seventh game at Boston Saturday. And the question will be, can the home court prove to be the charm again? Because the home court advantage has been true to form throughout the first six games of this series.
Certainly the Pistons came pretty close in the last game. They did not play well in the first two games in Boston. They had the game in their pocket in game five, and they gave it away to Boston. I think it's going to be just a sensational seventh game. Everybody thinks the home court is so important in seventh game. I believe that the officiating really is done on a non-partial basis. They usually put the best officials in those games, not to be affected by the crowd. It's anybody's ball game, has been my experience.
I think you're right. We've seen the Celtics win so many seventh games, as Pat O'Brien explained, and one time we saw Philadelphia come in and exorcise those ghosts with Billy Cunningham leading the Sixers to a seventh game win. Sam Vincent. And a foul with 1 second to play. Dantley with 24. Vinnie Johnson with 24. And the rookies played well. You see them there. Rodman and Sally. And what about Rick Mahorn with 14 points and 17 rebounds? And the Celtics, who played it tight for three quarters without Robert Parish tonight.
And I thought it was a great coaching effort by Chuck Daly, too, because what he did was put the foot on the gas pedal at just the right time to create that explosion against the Celtics. The addition of Sally and Rodman and the usage of them on the fast break was exceptional.
The Pistons win it. And they're going to have to break a five-year jinx on Saturday at 3:30 if the Detroit Pistons are to be the surprise teams to represent the East against the powerful Los Angeles Lakers in the NBA Finals. And right now, let's go to Pat O'Brien.
All right, Dick, thank you. With Isaiah Thomas and Coach Daly, congratulations, first of all. Is seven going to be a lucky number for you?
Better be.
How about the game on Saturday, Isaiah? Can you win in the Garden?
Well, we're definitely capable of winning. If we play good basketball and we do the things that coach wants us to do, we should have a victory.
How do you feel about tonight's game?
Happy.
Is always this hot in here?
Yeah.
Let's go to Coach Daly. What was the difference tonight, Coach?
I think we just kind of outlasted them. They played a great basketball game without Parish. Played very well, hung in there. We kind of hung in there, and we got a group together at the end. Our bench played very well. I didn't have to use Dantley and Lambeer late, so that may help us. I hope so. It was a very hard game. Incredible weather.
I got a real tough question for both of you. Are you having any fun?
What it's all about.
That's what it's all about. That's right, Patrick.
Okay, that's what it's all about, they say. And Dick and Tommy will be back as the Pistons are going to the Boston Garden for Game 7. We'll be back in a moment.
One word distinguishes the American Express card from the others. Member. To us, Mr. Ryan is a member.
So excited.
And at American Express, our card members are entitled to a world of privileges.
Don't stop now. You gotta keep it going all night.
We lost our card, our cash.
Even our passport.
You've come to the right place. I can help you.
That's great.
I'm glad we stayed an extra day.
I'm glad we have the American Express card.
She's so lovely.
She reminds me of you.
Members carry our promise of respect, recognition, unsurpassed personal service. Membership has its privileges. To apply by phone, call 1-800-THE-CARD.
Disposable has a new blade angle that's designed to give you a light touch. An easy touch that's closer than ever.
A touch that's easy makes me understand. When it comes to love, I want a slow hand.
The new Shift Disposable for the easy touch.
And the Detroit Pistons winning 113-105. And our Miller Lite player of the game coming off the bench is Vinnie Johnson, who scored 12 of his 24 points in the crunch when they needed it in the fourth period. And Miller is proud to present a check for $1,000 to the Multiple Sclerosis Society on behalf of the Microwave, Vinnie Johnson. We'll be back.
If you can dream it, you can do it. Today, the Prudential can show you a new world of financial opportunities. Look to the rock for mutual funds, stocks and bonds. Feel its strength in CDs, insurance and mortgages. With the right choices, the right guidance, the sky's the limit. The Prudential. Your rock in financial services.
Anybody can see that Miller High Life looks darker and richer than the other leading premium. And the people at Miller showed me why.
This is where it all starts.
Now tell me about this.
This is barley.
I saw how barley becomes malt.
What we have here is dark roasted barley malt.
And the roasted malt Miller blends in to make their beer darker.
You really can see the difference.
I learned a lot from these people. And if making a beer that's dark and rich is the American way, I'd say Miller's doing a pretty good job of it.
Another blistering shooting night for the Pistons, 57% for the game, and they've been red hot as of late as they win the game. And so for Tom Heinsohn and Pat O'Brien, I'm Dick Stockton saying so long from the Pontiac Silverdome in Pontiac, Michigan. The final score, 113-105 Detroit. Join us Saturday for the seventh and deciding game in this Eastern Conference final between the Pistons and the Celtics. CBS is a presentation of CBS Sports.
United can show you the old Hawaii where time takes a rest, and you can become yourself again. So come become Hawaii with the airline that's been her friend for nearly 40 years. United.
When you look for champions, look to the NBA playoffs on CBS Sports. This is CBS.
One of these Japanese luxury sedans comes with a 2.4-liter electronically fuel-injected engine. One comes with a 6-speaker AM-FM stereo cassette system. At no extra charge. One supplies a theft deterrent system as standard equipment, and one retained a phenomenal 99% of its original retail value over the past year. Which one? The less expensive one. Mitsubishi Galant. Immediate delivery now at your Mitsubishi Motors dealer. In the splendor of his palace, Caesar treated his guests to spectacular battles between champion gladiators. Thousand years later, he still does. Caesar's Palace. Relive the legend.
Before you bet your business on an unproven PC, see how AT&T comes through. Right now, every AT&T PC you buy saves you money on your next PC. The more AT&T PCs you add,